is so stupid, it's positively brilliant.
Yep, Charlamagne the God.
Schulze.
We are the brilliant idiot.
Wait.
White Lightning.
White Lightning. We're going to get to it. Hold on. Wax his hair as well. I'm not mentioning the other person. From websites, today's show is brought to you by Squarespace. From websites and online stores, the marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business, all right? Keyword, run your business, all right? There are no hidden fees or price hikes, and all websites are optimized for mobile, and it's so simple. Start with a design template and use drag and drop tools to make it your own. Head to squarespace.com/idiot for a free trial. When you're ready to launch, use the offer code idiot to save 10% off your first purchase. Now let's start the show. Should we just get into the what a fucking idiot portion of the show?
I think we should. I really think we should, because it's unbelievable that Taylor thought that she could challenge White Lightning.
Excuse me.
And you that was maybe disrespectful.
Last week, you was talking about last week you was talking about how you were so obsessed, Charlamagne, that he was upping women and everything else like that. You need your fucking privilege, men, white privilege, whatever you want to do.
I don't know what the hell you talking about, right?
You don't know what I'm talking about.
What that got to do with you losing this race?
You know what I'm talking about?
What you got to do with losing this race?
You know what I'm talking about now?
I don't know what that got to do with you losing this race.
Yo, let's just talk about you lost. Let's just talk about how you lost.
Let's talk about it. Let's talk about how I have you in the right position right now.
Which position?
We're talking about the wrong
first.
We're going.
You got me in first.
We're going.
First position.
We're going to have a rematch.
Okay.
For what?
Watch
out. Oh, now you don't want to have a rematch.
But I blew her out the water.
Exactly.
You pulled the hamstring trying to keep up. Like, your body shut down. Your body went to the point in which it can go, and then it could go no more, and you tried to push it past that, and it shut down. It said, you don't race.
That's
it said, you don't race against White Lightning.
Rematches happen. Rematches happen when something is close.
Controversial.
Yeah. There's nothing controversial about it.
A little bit, though. You kind of jumped off a little bit.
Stop. No, time out. Are you serious?
No, you are just crazy,
a little bit.
You are
crazy. No, no, no. He did, though.
You was already moving.
Hey.
I'll beat your ass in a race.
Bullshit.
I'll beat your ass in a race.
I'll be ready soon.
Right downstairs right now.
I'll be ready real soon.
Why are you ready soon?
Now we got excuses. I could beat Muhammad Ali, but now
listen,
we got excuses.
I was racing.
You need both your Achilles to race me?
Whoa.
You need both your Achilles to race me?
I was racing dogs, bro.
White Lightning, go. White Lightning, go.
I ain't worried. I damn sure ain't worried.
I never thought Taylor could beat Andrew, by the way.
Of course not.
Go back. I said Taylor's too low to the ground.
It's too low to the ground. You're a woman. There's certain things you never can overcome.
I know women that can beat you. I was just going against Alice.
So wait,
I said,
so confident.
Let me give you your money back so you can give it to Al on camp.
Andrew.
I gave this to you, so I didn't have to do this.
Andrew,
Hold on, Taylor. Let's see the exchange of goods. Come on.
Wax, I did this on purpose.
Give him that money, yo. Give him that money. Enjoy that, Al.
Excuse me.
That's what happens when you bet on Schulz.
White Lightning.
I already told Alice I didn't get him a gift before opening
it. He gave Alice that money like it was child support. Like, I don't want to do this. Fuck.
That's what
this is. You think I give a fuck if you lost 100?
I got child support. The fuck is wrong with you?
They're in fighting.
Taylor, I'm going to be honest with you. I can't believe you're making excuses about this.
I'm not making no excuses.
I'm making no excuses.
You got your ass washed.
I'm making no excuses. So you're not down for a rematch?
Of course. Listen, I'll rematch you today, tomorrow, yesterday.
Why do you not want one?
No,
y'all in the same position I'm in.
So when do you want to come out? When do you want a rematch?
Yeah.
When?
How you come and say no accident about it?
Exactly. And what changed between last week and this week?
Yeah.
Do you even hear what I said?
What?
He was complaining about not bigging up.
Me not being up.
Not bigging men up.
What are you talking about?
You don't remember that. You don't remember that conversation.
I don't know what you're talking about. And I remember it was Father's Day coming up last week, and I had a very impassioned speech about how important men are.
What that got to do with you losing the race?
Because I gave him his flowers because he was so upset about it.
Yo, can I ask you a question?
I don't know what you're talking about.
This is important. After that speech that I gave about how amazing men are, you had the opportunity to shut me up. And what happened?
No, because I felt like you really needed it.
Your hamstring only went 3/4 of the way there.
I feel like you really, okay? Excuse me. I felt like
just
you really needed it.
Just like the wage gap. The hamstring gap.
Oh, my God. So instead of just taking it, say, you know
just
what,
take I the lost. L, you lost.
You gonna really yo, come and backpedal? Yo,
you really think wait, you can beat me in the race?
Hold on, time. I have to join this meeting.
Why?
The people on Reddit are like, please leave.
What do you mean?
Taylor, what do you mean?
Come on, Taylor. Taylor. Damn, I saw how quick you just got off that chair. Where was that last week?
Taylor, where that was all that speed, fast. Yo?
Where was that speed at,
Taylor? Well, I gave you your bread, man. I'm a man of my word. Fuck. I didn't want to do that. I've never been a good word again.
It was a good race. No, it was a sore loser.
I am.
Listen.
You can't be a sore loser. Especially when you was talking the talk. She
also,
lost.
I'm a sore winner. We both can't be sore. There's too much soreness going around. You know if you lose to me, you're never going to stop hearing it.
Ask Jay Williams.
So Jay Williams a decade ago. I still talk about that shit every single day.
That's different, though. That's Jay Williams. I mean, goddamn.
But she was talking too crazy, though.
Because nobody cares about details. You know I beat Jay Williams one-on-one. That's it.
Yeah, that's fire. Nobody cares.
Doesn't matter he's 5-7 points.
Yeah, nobody asking the details about that. But beating Taylor in a 100-meter dash, yeah, that's not as exciting.
No.
She was talking so greasy.
She was talking crazy.
I'm talking about for years, though. You kind of shut her up for years, though.
That's a good-ass point. She's been talking about this for years.
She's been a track star.
Yeah. She said she's a track star. She's like, Philly. I run an 11-second 100-meter dash. Well, shit, I'm Usain Bolt.
She's talking about Kobe used to come to her track meets and all this.
No, she didn't.
Yeah, she did.
She did.
I don't remember that one now.
She said Kobe used to come to the track meets. Yeah.
He was her neighbor. What are you talking about? He used to come to her track meets and all that.
He said Shaq came one time.
The funniest shit was Taylor announced that she had to go get a meeting, like, right?
Hold the presses, everybody. Taylor got a meeting. Hey, y'all want to hold your breath until Taylor gets
back? Oh, man. Your boy Andrew Yang dropped out. He conceded. Who won the New York
Eric
race?
Eric Adams, I think, was in the lead, but that's my guy.
I don't understand that race rank shit. What's the shit called? The voter ranked?
Are we ranking races?
No. Is that shit called?
Yeah, because when you vote, you put like...
You got to vote 1, 2, 5? Yeah. Like, what the fuck is the point of that?
Like your first choice, second choice, third choice.
Why?
I don't know. It don't make sense.
Have your way, man. I forgot what they call it.
I heard about this. I think this is how it works in like parliamentary systems where... Don't let me start.
I don't know why they do it.
And I was like, nah, I'm not gonna
go. I just don't see the point. Like, doesn't that defeat the whole purpose of voting? Like, you're going to vote for one person. Yeah. They were saying they were doing it because they don't want to. They want to prevent runoffs and shit like that. But maybe
like second counts for half a vote or some shit.
Yeah, Andrew Yang, man, I fuck with Andrew. I still think Andrew has a lot of great ideas. But man, he talk about somebody who blew a 3-0 lead.
Son, I told him and his people, son. I told his PR guy, his chief of whatever PR, I said, he cannot be mayor of New York unless he comes on Flagrant 2 podcast.
He did a lot, though, man. I mean, he played basketball.
See, that is the guy.
Close to Harlem.
He went to Bodegas. You ain't see the girl when the girl was to pull her, try to pull her titties out and got down on the ground and started pulling her skirt up?
And what happened?
He was like, if you do whatever you want to do.
I think that...
You want to see my titties? He's like, I don't know. Do whatever you want to do. They was at the park.
And that with Andrew Yang?
Yeah.
Andrew really is.
I don't know, bro.
I promise you it is.
Yeah.
I ain't see that. You know what's crazy about Andrew? Andrew is like I guess he did too much. Because it's like, you know, it's like the guy who like talked his way out of the vagina.
That's me. That's my whole life.
You know what I'm saying? You're not a woman. Be like, I was going to give you something. And then you started talking. Yeah.
You know what it was? He was afraid. He played prevent defense. He had it in his grasp.
Yeah.
And everybody thought that he was going to do it. I think he even had the lead. And then after that, he got pussy. And his camp got pussy. And they didn't want to ruffle any feathers. And they're like, we're just going to coast to the finish line. And New Yorkers do not like that. We would rather you take a real hard stance about some shit we don't agree with, but we know that you're tough.
Yeah.
Then you just try to placate. You say you're pro one thing. Then you flip-flop once you get some pushback. That Eric Adams dude was like, yo, this is how you find drugs in your kid's closet. And then we were all like, yo, why you snitch on your kids? But parents were like, nah, all right, I like that.
No, I mean, now is a good time for somebody like Eric Adams because yes. You know, New York is...
It's wild.
It looks bad. It looks like the Wild Wild West.
Really out of what's control. Andrew Yang going to do to clean up the streets?
That's what I'm saying.
Give people $1,000 for what?
Yeah, yeah. No, but listen, that would help clean up the streets too, though.
Son, no, it's not.
Provide people opportunity, give them money and resources.
Nah,
I mean,
that's not true.
Been giving people money for the last...
Because every time they give money, they go ahead, they doing more bad
more
stuff with their money.
Shit.
And it depends, right?
The government giving people money for the last year.
And they've been wild, and that's why they wild. I'm not saying they don't give them no bread.
People are wild because they broke. That dude got robbed in the Bronx last night for a $3,000 chain. They killed the driver in the head for a freaking chain.
All right, but he
that's because people are hurting.
Where do you think they got the money to get the gun? Where do you think they got the all the shit? Listen, I'm not saying don't give them no bread, but they are really out here wilding.
You have to have a combination of both. It has to be law enforcement
and coming on flagrant too.
And it has to be law enforcement, and you got to put resources in these poor disenfranchised areas.
Yes, yes. You do.
You got
to. I definitely want
to
get them bread, but what I've seen with getting a lot of people bread right now, I guess whenever anytime you just give somebody something,
yeah.
They don't cherish it.
You give
them opportunity.
You give them opportunity with jobs. You put more trade schools in these communities.
Yeah,
like you give
like
them
that.
Something to do. Open up the rec centers.
Just don't get them cash.
I'm with you on giving opportunity, yes, giving people the opportunity to work. And like obviously you need to give cash to some people who are really in need. If you got a mom, she got two kids at home,
Peace.
She gotta look after the kids. What the Peace. Fuck she's supposed to work 40 hours a week? It's not gonna be possible.
What you said just now helps too, right? Because if I'm a mom and I gotta work 2 or 3 jobs, who's watching the kids?
Yeah, daycare, all that kind of shit. 100% we're on board with that. But the Andrew Yang shit that blew my fucking mind is I thought this motherfucker was rich.
He's not?
He got like $1 million.
What do you mean? You are balling. Go ahead, show that. Oh, he got a million. A measly million. What do you mean?
Who are you to give away 1,000 everybody? That's what I'm talking about. You talking about giveaway 1,000? You need 1,000. You know what I'm saying? I'm not talking about 1 million isn't a lot.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
if you
yeah.
couldn't be the I know business, I know how economies work, I know how the system works, but you have got 1 million. That's
a million. A lot of money, bro.
Sometimes it's not a lot of money for you to be a financial expert.
Yeah, you're supposed to have that.
Like if I'm going to financial expert for advice, he got to have more than 1 million.
Yeah, I don't think I don't consider Andrew Yang a financial expert. It's like universal basic
income. That's all he's talking
about. Universal basic income was a principle that started with Martin Luther King Jr.
It's something he needs because he's coming on broke. So, you know what I'm saying? He needs a job. I thought this guy was worth hundreds of millions of dollars. I thought he was a genius businessman.
Yeah. Really?
Why are you telling me about money if you don't have more money than all these other motherfuckers?
But it's not like he's telling people how to, you know, balance their books. He's just like, look, universal basic income, people can use an extra $1,000 a month. That's not fucking a financial advisor. Wax could say that.
He wouldn't.
I'm definitely trying to get $1,000, whatever that means. How can I get that?
See how it works? That motherfucker just came out like, yo, everybody gets $1,000. And we were like, all right, this guy's kind of onto some shit.
Yeah.
And we didn't even look to the credentials.
Martin Luther King Jr., man, he's the one who invented the concept of universal basic income. Martin Luther King Jr.
He invented it or communism invented it?
The first time I ever heard of universal basic income was Martin Luther King Jr.
Mm.
He was the one saying people need... I don't know if he ever had a dollar amount, but they need a stipend a month in order just to take care of their basic needs. He got it all. That's all MLK Jr. Mm. Bernie Sanders, they all got it from MLK Jr. Universal basic income.
But it's just 1,000 or 1,000 every month or something like that.
I thought he said 1,000 every month, right?
That's what Yang
New Yorkers, said. Yeah. But it wasn't going to be for all New Yorkers. It was going to only be for like a quarter million or something like that. I just think that he came off as a little inauthentic. New Yorkers sniffed that out, and it's hard. It's very hard to come off inauthentic in 2021. Like, you can fake being real. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And even when people were saying, like, oh, Andrew Yang, he's goofy. Yeah.
He's playing basketball.
We like when he's goofy.
He is. He's that. So to me, I thought he was being authentic, but to some people, it's like, nope.
He didn't want to piss off anybody, and I tell you, that is the downfall. In New York, we're used to being pissed off.
Yeah.
It's not a big deal to piss us off. We like it if you piss us off, as long as you stand for something.
Yeah.
Just stand for your shit. Take a stand.
Yeah, the days of politicians playing both sides is over.
Done.
And like you gotta believe in something. Yeah. There has to be a mass group of people that see you and know this is what you're committed to.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you win elections.
Yeah, we feel comfortable then. Even if we don't like you and I know where you stand, I'm like, all right, I know how to work, I know how to deal with this shit.
When you come in here and I'm like, I don't even know what this motherfucker's going to do.
Yeah.
How do I plan taxes? How do I plan business shit? How do I plan hiring if I don't know the positions this guy's going to put me in?
Yeah.
You, if you get a Republican or a Democrat in office, I know how I can plan for both of those motherfuckers.
Yeah.
A flip-flopper?
He just want to play basketball.
Who?
That's the only time I've ever seen him is playing basketball.
He's playing basketball?
That's it.
You ever see when they asked him what his favorite Jay-Z song was?
No.
And he said a Jay-Z and Linkin Park record? Like, bro.
I mean, that makes sense. That makes sense. Part.
Yeah. Nobody in the history of life is
playing basketball in the park.
I've become so numb.
I've never even heard that record.
I could see you there.
That's from the Collision Course album?
I'm about to shoot this whole room up.
I've never heard that shit.
I got hyped just right then, yo.
Jay-Z on that song?
I was about to shoot the whole room up.
I've never heard that shit ever.
Hov on that song?
Jay-Z and, what's the name? Linkin Park. Bro, the way that song just hit me, y'all could be dead right now if I kept singing that song.
I don't like white men constantly talking about doing mass shootings, bro.
You said
it a few times.
Hey. It's Candyman. You play that song one more time, it might be over for all this. Yo, you play Linkin Park three times in a row for a
while. Nobody believed the kid who was kept saying.
No, for real. The kid kept saying he's gonna do it.
Nobody believed
that. I was like, leave little Andy alone. Little Andy doesn't mean it.
He coming here trenched up.
Lord have mercy.
He's going through the whole act.
like fucking Terminator. Like, yo, what's up?
Pull the gun out. Like, ah, it's so funny.
Until he starts shooting. So you like Eric Adams from New York?
I only saw that one video of him, and I loved it. I saw one video. I don't know anything about his posse.
I remember that where he was like, this is how you find kids in your drug room. This is how you find guns.
Yeah.
I'm like, who the fuck is this little kid?
I love this.
Who is this little Nino Brown to be?
He's a badass little kid who knows how to hide his guns in drugs.
He's black or white?
He's black.
Black guy?
Eric, yeah. I got Eric on my Audible project, We've Got Answers, that I put out a couple months ago.
Oh, and he's on it.
Yeah, Eric's
great.
On it.
Great.
Right, part of the black brain trust that I assembled, Eric Adams is definitely one of them.
He was commissioner?
He was what was he in Brooklyn? Oh, shit, why is this slipping my mind right fucking
police,
now?
Police commissioner or something
He was
like that?
The Brooklyn Borough President.
Ah, okay.
That's what he was. Brooklyn Borough President, Eric Adams. So listen, I guess salute to Eric Adams. I don't know if it's official yet.
Yeah, neither do I. And that was the primary, right? Like, so he's still got to win against.
Huh?
I thought that was the primary.
Yeah. It was a primary, but in New York, whoever wins the Democratic primary is going to go on to be.
Hold on, that wasn't the election on Tuesday?
Nah. Because now
what
on
the fuck?
That's like a scrimmage?
Nah. Watch Andrew Yang runs for the other side, flip-flopping that.
Hold on, that wasn't the election on Tuesday?
Nah. The Democratic primaries.
Nah, I love Andrew Yang, but yo, his chief of staff played pussy with us, bro. That shit bothered me. He kept saying, we're going to do it, confirming and then ghosting us. And I told him to his face, I said, if he doesn't come on the podcast, he will lose.
Yeah.
I was like, you cannot come. I told him, you cannot win the election for mayor of New York without coming to the Flagrant 2 podcast.
That's why you moved back to New York, right? You moved back to New York just to interview Andrew Yang. Yeah.
Not to interview him. I moved back to New York to ensure a good mayor.
Okay? Tell him what you did today, though.
What I do today? I called his ass.
You called Yang?
No, I called the little pussy boy that was avoiding my calls.
His chief of staff?
Yeah.
What'd you say to him?
I said,
see?
I said, well.
This
motherfucker's crazy.
What do you say, Alex? Tell me, Alex. What happened?
He's like, I told you, you don't come on the podcast, you ain't winning shit. Take your pussy ass back.
What do you say?
Nah, this is a voicemail. They ain't picking
up. Oh, you left. Oh, my God. Yeah.
Even worse.
Hey, this is what happens when you ghost me, bro.
You want it old, man?
Say what?
You want it old?
Yeah.
You write letters.
I was hurt.
Has a girl ever ghosted you in real life?
No.
Oh.
Okay. I mean, yeah, of course. Are you kidding?
That's all part of this.
Yeah. Girls have ghosted, of course.
How did you react? Like that?
No. I had other candidates.
Yeah, ranked choice voting.
but I tell you this, those that ghosted and all of a sudden, you know, in a little Netflix special or some YouTube shit start popping.
The Rock post you on Instagram.
The Rock post on Instagram.
Congratulations.
Then they hop back up in the DMs.
Congratulations. You know I see There's, you.
That, I, yeah, exactly.
I see you, big
Congratulations.
Head.
Congratulations.
Back then, they didn't want you. Now I'm hot. They all on you.
I see you ugly.
You know what I'm saying?
I see you ugly.
I see your little ugly ass. Your ugly ass winning.
Can I hit ugly? Big head.
Now you want this pussy, huh?
Wait, what?
Huh? What? I'm going to be honest with y'all. I don't even know where the fuck we ended because we had some technical difficulties. We had to stop. So whatever the conversation was.
It was getting wild. But basically, if I say it's time to come on Flagrant 2 or else you don't got a chance, now you know I'm dead serious. And first of all, I just want to make this point very clear. I extended that to somebody who is a political nobody.
Yeah.
I've had mayors on the podcast before. We had the mayor of Miami, not the wannabe mayor. I was willing to throw him an alley-oop.
Yang was popping on a national level, though, because of the presidential.
He ain't never won nothing.
No, he definitely never won nothing. He definitely,
you know what I'm saying? Andrew, popular dude, but never won nothing. He never been a politician before.
I wonder if he regrets now not taking a position in the Biden administration.
They'll place him. He's part of that whole thing.
You think now, even still after the fact?
They pulled him in and this is what you do. The guarantee. They tried to run him in New York. It didn't work. But like the establishment is like, yeah, he's their guy. Yeah. Or they just put him back on CNN and he keeps on spouting their shit.
He'll be on CNN. I guess he'll still do his political pundit thing. I think he already got a podcast.
Yeah. What we liked about him is we thought he was an outsider. And I think that they pulled him in. They were like,
I think he came off a little too politician-y in his run for New York as well. That's what it was. Yeah, and I agree with that. Because it was a lot of, like, he had a lot of Bernie-ness with him. But it seemed like he was leaning a little too left. You know what I mean? But you're right, though. If you don't stand for anything, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for any motherfucking thing. Damn, you know what I'm saying? And he goddamn fell down those polls. That's the fact. What do you think of people getting charged to get vaccinated, bro?
Wait, what was that?
Like, they're finding people. What was that? What's the school? What's the story? Click on that story.
That's kind of wild.
Alex? If we only had Taylor to not know what was going on with the story. Hold on, let me pull it up, man.
Yeah, it's not even a link. It's
just charging people if they don't get vaccinated.
Hold on. I'm going to tell you right now.
It's kind of wild.
Because I want you to have the context of this, because this is... I don't understand this. Okay.
Like charging money or like with a crime?
Students are suing Indiana University in federal court over vaccine mandate. Okay.
Why don't they just do it at home and just do it like...
Do in homeschool?
The mandate requires students, faculty, and staff to be vaccinated or get an exemption for religious or medical reasons before starting the fall term.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
It's tricky, man. It's tricky because you can't even really be honest about how you feel about the vaccine because Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter will take your whole shit down.
Mm.
Like the exact things that we've all been saying, we've all been curious about that were called conspiracy theories are now coming out, right? Mm-hmm. People initially like, yo, this shit might be made in a lab. And they go, oh, and it was leaked by China. Oh, you racist. How could you say that? And that's so fucked up. And now it comes out. Yeah, it's most likely made in a lab. You know?
Yeah.
Same thing goes with the vaccine. It's like, there are going to be people that have adverse reactions to the vaccines. And it's okay if, as an average citizen, you feel scared about taking it. Yeah. I got the vaccine. I got it really probably because I just want to travel. So I was just on some like spoiled hoe shit. I'm just being a spoiled hoe. I'd like to travel. So how do I get it? And I also got it, if I'm to say, being selfless, is like, I go do shows on the road where I bring large groups of people into one place.
But are all of them vaccinated?
They might not be, but the least I could do for them.
But you can still get it.
You still get it though.
Yeah, but I could provide more protection to passing it on.
Okay.
You can still get it, but you can't. One, it's much harder to get. And two, you're not going to show symptoms.
Okay. What about the Houston Methodist Hospital that said 153 employees either resigned or were fired because they refused to get a COVID-19 vaccine because it was a hospital policy?
I mean,
that's not right. Does my body, my choice not apply to vaccines?
No. I mean, your kids got to get vaccinated to go to school.
I'm not against vaccines. I'm just saying with this new COVID vaccine, the FDA has not approved. They only approved for emergency use. So if there are side effects, I can't sue no fucking body. So if I just want to pump my brakes for a minute and wait until, you know, to see what happens with this shit, I'm wrong.
How about this? Let me throw something at you. You tell me how you feel. There's a drug called ivermectin. And
that sounds like a name. That sounds like a financial advisor.
Yeah.
Ivermectin. Talk to ivermectin.
And he said, or the drug apparently might be helpful with dealing with the coronavirus symptoms after you already have. There's been other drugs that have come out, you know, that some say are good and can potentially help.
Mm-hmm.
Remdesivir, whatever that shit was, hydroxychloroquine, zinc, D3, all these.
I heard about zinc.
Vitamin D3, these things. It's been, some people have said that there might have had information that this was useful. And by they, I mean like the pharmaceutical companies that are putting out the vaccine, and that they've quieted the effectiveness of that drug in curing the coronavirus or curing the symptoms of the coronavirus, so that they could push out the vaccine.
I've never heard that drug. I've heard hydroxychloroquine was definitely fucking people up.
Hydroxychloroquine.
Whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
I actually ordered some off Amazon, but I think I ordered some other shit that started with hydro, but I thought it was chloroquine. Yeah, I got that shit sitting in the cabinet right
I really think if they stopped doing a needle shit, if they do like a pill or something like that or something to drink, I think it'd be much better though.
They can do it up your butt.
I'm not doing that shit. I ain't doing it.
They can do it up your butt. I read today that if you refuse to get the vaccine, then they'll send you to jail and you got to get butt injections.
Jail it is.
I was on CNN. I sent that one.
Jail it is.
Listen. What do you mean?
What do you mean?
What do you mean, jail it is?
Send you to jail.
Here come Cannonball. Listen, what do you mean? There it is.
Really,
you didn't see that headline?
Taylor!
You didn't see this headline?
Yo, why Taylor get upset?
What happened?
Taylor just walked out.
You see that headline?
Hold on. Strongman threatens vaccine decliners with jail. Butt injections.
See what I'm saying? That was on CNN this morning, bro. It said strong man threatens vaccine decliners with jail, and then it says butt injections.
You got nothing to
do. Come on, son.
This is Maria Santana, who's a CNN anchor and correspondent. I don't know what the fuck they was talking about.
She got butt injections.
No, man.
What about all the people inside the hospital? Why they not? If they must know more than we do. They not trying to do it.
Listen, I know doctors that aren't trying to do it. I just think it's unconstitutional, and this is by somebody who's not any expert in the Constitution at all. It feels unconstitutional to fire people because they don't want to get the fucking vaccine. To fine kids in college because they don't want to get the fucking vaccine.
The Constitution is wrong.
That don't feel right. That feels right to y'all?
No,
it doesn't feel right. But it's a tricky one, man. It's like, let's say, for example, 1% of people... 1% of, okay, let's say 1% of people die because of COVID.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And let's say 0.5% of people die because of the vaccine. But everybody gets to get back to normal. It's like, should we take on that sacrifice for the greater good?
But
should
we take on that risk? Though.
People are, though. It?
What?
They already are.
Is it really the truth, though?
But that's the thing.
You gotta wait.
Well, that's the thing. We don't know the truth. And this isn't even our fault. It's like we've lost faith in our institutions because they motherfucking lie all the time.
Oh, and by the way, let's not get it fucked up. America don't give a fuck about casualties when it comes to the money.
Nah.
Okay. Yeah, they know they America the already knows that they're gonna lose some people in various industries. You know what I mean? But if it makes money, who gives a shit? That's 100%. How that's the American
way. We just don't want to be
it's fucked up, but that's the way it is.
All we care about is money, man. Greed is how you guess. That's why. That's why China's being successful. They're not even trying to fight wars with us. They're just like, yo, we will just offer them money, and they will do anything we want for money.
That's fucked up.
John Cena bent over and grabbed his ankles and apologized in perfect Mandarin for recognizing Taiwan as a country. You saw that, right?
I'm gonna be honest with you. That story sounded way better until you told me what he actually bent over and grabbed his ankles for. I was like, really? I didn't see John Cena bend over and grab his ankles? When did that happen? Not that I'm interested in that kind of stuff, but I was like, where was that visual?
You know what I mean, though, right?
Like, I'm trying to say, I'm like, oh, this guy really didn't grab his ankles, though,
He grabbed his ankles for China. He grabbed his ankles for China.
What did he apologize to China for?
For recognizing Taiwan as a country.
Damn, John, you acting like an NBA player. I thought NBA players were the only people who
they want that money, bro.
They don't. That's what it all boils down to. And everybody needs to stop acting like they care about anything else. This is a capitalist country, and they will motherfucking sacrifice human beings
all day
to
long
to make sure that bottom line is still there. And it's that 100%. Goddamn almighty dollar.
100%.
Fucked up, but that's just the way it is.
And it is fucked up. We just not used to seeing it at home. We're okay with sacrificing people overseas. We're okay with motherfuckers in sweatshops and shit making our clothes. We're okay with these senseless wars so our gas is cheap. But the second it comes home and it's like, wait, we could potentially die.
But it's been home, though. The tobacco industry.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like people make multi-billions of dollars.
Pharmaceutical industry.
Yes.
Got all these people hooked on fentanyl
Absolutely. Percocets and all this other shit. Like they purposely know these things are addictive, especially cigarettes, bro. Yeah. They know this shit is addictive, and they still motherfucking sell it, even though it kills millions of people.
Twix?
Huh?
Like, I think the sugar is like cheap cocaine. So I say Twix.
Why
too.
Twix?
That's fucked me up.
Twix?
Why do you like Twix, bro?
I don't
like
know, man. It looks like candy. Twin dicks.
It's two dicks.
No, it ain't.
Yo, because.
You know Twix is French.
Why?
Twix is French with chocolate dicks.
No, it ain't.
Twin chocolate dicks.
Twin chocolate dick.
Twin Snicker.
Say what?
That's something that really satisfies you.
That's French for black dick. But you don't like big dicks. You like small dicks. There's more of them.
I don't know what the fuck happened just now, but Twix is cheap cocaine. I think sugar is.
Yeah, but of all the different things you could choose to put inside your mouth.
I chop it up, though.
You chop the dick. Whoa. You chop the dick up?
No, I guarantee I do this with the Twix every time.
You can't just put pieces. The whole Twix in your mouth.
No way. I'm going to put it in my mouth and like kept it there.
You put both of them in your mouth?
No, hell no. Just I don't even like smoking my blunts like that. I like smoking my blunts like this.
You're a liar. You got to stop telling this lie.
So I'll smoke a blunt like this?
You got to stop telling this lie, yo. Stop telling this lie before I tell the story. I'm not going to tell the story.
I never smoked my blunt. How you smoking a blunt like this?
Stop telling the lie.
I smoke my blunt.
Remember Wax said, I don't even put my lips on the blunt.
I don't.
Like what?
Yeah, especially if I'm smoking with somebody, I always smoke just like this.
Nah, bro.
I never put my lips on it.
If you think...
Yeah, that's...
If you think that look makes you look any more manly,
yeah, that's a little gayer, bro.
That's definitely gayer.
That's a little gang-dangling,
bro. Not put your lips on the blunt. It's like you're sucking a little Snicker.
Nope.
That's all. That's all.
I cut him up.
What else we got? What else we got this week, guys?
Because
yo, Taylor's back. Like yo, Taylor's back. Ooh. She's made her second return. She walked out immediately after the first one.
But I could do stuff.
Why are you upset?
I'm like mad stressed out right now.
But why are you so stressed? Why don't you?
She lost that race and that shit got to live online forever,
yeah,
bro.
Dude, honestly, I would say run it off, but that might take too long.
Maybe y'all should try racing downhill.
Do you want to and just ball up or what?
Back pedal.
Taylor, come on.
Taylor, you can't sit in here pouting because you lost the race.
I'm not pouting.
You're definitely pouting.
I'm not worried about y'all. Y'all think I was worried about y'all last week or anything? I don't get it.
That's a song by Destiny's Child.
It's Beyonce.
No, it's not.
It's just Beyonce. It is. She the lead singer of Beyonce.
That's not Destiny's Child. That's Beyonce.
If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. honey, I can see the stars all away from here.
That's Beyonce, too?
That's Beyonce, baby.
Come on, yo.
The woman that Trick Daddy said
Mary
cannot
J. Blige.
Sing.
Wait, what?
You didn't hear Trick Daddy?
No, I heard Trick Daddy, bro.
Trick Daddy said Mary can't sing, and Jay-Z was never anybody's favorite rapper or greatest rapper.
He also said that he's scared of... bugs more than bees. Or no, he's scared of roaches more than bees.
Because after the beehive combo.
Yeah.
Which I don't agree with because roaches don't bite.
He needs to run for mayor of New
roaches
York.
Bite. No, I say shit.
Roaches don't
like
bite.
Roaches do bite.
You got bit by a roach?
Yeah, I got bit by a roach before. Roaches lay eggs in you. What are you talking about?
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
What?
Whoa,
whoa,
whoa. A roach nutted in you?
You let a roach nut in you? Son, a roach got you pregnant, son? You let a roach get you pregnant?
If a roach bite you or a spider bite you, they lay an egg in you.
I never heard a roach bite.
Go ahead, look it up.
I don't let any man lay eggs in me.
Can somebody look it up real quick so I don't look fucking crazy?
I don't let any man lay eggs in me ever, yo. I'm from New York. Yo, in New York, we don't let motherfuckers roll up and lay eggs in us.
For real, man, and a bunch of shit come out of you. Huh? Bite the shit out of you. And the shit.
I didn't know cockroaches eat meat either. Cockroaches are omnivores that eat plants and meat. They have been recorded to eat human flesh of both the living and the dead. Although they are more likely to take a bite of fingernails, eyelashes, feet, and hands, the bites may cause irritations, lesions, and swelling. I never knew that.
Which one of them lay eggs in you?
Wow. Why roaches just crawling on you? You just got everything crawling on you.
Wow.
Because that's why do you have a mice?
Yes. That's why I'm
saying. Wow.
Yes.
I mean, that's crazy.
Where'd he nutting you at, Wax?
He didn't lay an egg in me, but I got bit by a roach before.
How you know it was a roach?
Because we had roaches.
Yeah, but I'm saying like, no. I'm saying, no. Listen to my question because I'm saying, because
it was my dog.
You could have been falling asleep.
It was my dog.
I think I know how I look.
I'm saying you could have been slept. And a spider
Taylor coming through with heat. Taylor back on the podcast with heat. That's all I'm talking about, girl.
That's right, Taylor.
Come on.
First you don't succeed, try and try again, all right?
First you don't succeed. Okay?
Don't you be like Ben Simmons. You ain't scared to shoot, right, Taylor?
No, you not.
It don't matter how many times you miss. Shoot.
Say my name.
TLC. You're
acting kind of crazy. Ain't calling me baby. What's up, Jay? Say my name. Come on, Taylor. Tell him to say your name. Tell him to say your name in these Reddit streets.
Oh, my God. You know what's so crazy, though?
What? Taylor about to throw her laptop in my head?
Don't let him see you like this, Taylor. That's fucking
we
him.
Got a laptop.
You sat there for 5 minutes pouting, and you giving Reddit more ammunition.
First of all, if y'all gonna let me fucking talk.
Ooh, oh, shit. Who runs the world? Girls.
Time out. The floor is yours, Taylor. Go.
Let's see what this is.
Let's see if she goes.
All I was trying to say was because you could be sleeping.
You really came back to this?
Yes. Because y'all wasn't fucking letting me talk and making me think like I'm saying something stupid.
But who said that's not us making you seem like you're saying something
stupid. I'm not saying dumb. Something's dumb, but you're not letting me talk.
Okay, go ahead. What is it?
Doesn't matter now. I don't feel like it.
What?
It's all about a roach.
What?
Never mind.
Say what you gonna say.
Never mind.
You don't play around, bro. You roach.
Roaches bite.
It's just been a bad week for Philly. That's all. Taylor lost the race. Yeah. Sixers lost. Yo, you know what I'm saying?
A lot of L's for Philly. But you have to understand, they are survivors. You are a survivor. Keep on surviving.
Hey, you are Destiny's Child, Taylor.
Yes, you are.
You are. You are a child of destiny.
Destiny.
That's right. Now, do you want to finish about the roach?
I want to fight all y'all because
you lost the race and you want to fight us?
I don't give a fuck about losing or anything else like that. That's not. No, it's not.
Be honest, Taylor.
If I was that upset, I would have hit Andrew like, yo, take that down. I don't give a... I reposted the animation and everything.
This is a safe space.
Animation.
This is a safe space.
You're upset that you lost to Andrew.
Yeah.
Why would I be upset now?
Come on, talk to us. Tell us why. What about it really bothers you?
I don't start talking. I just start fighting, so... Let's move on.
Just come on.
Why? We're literally sitting here trying to cater to you.
I'ma cater to you, honey. This is your day.
Come on, girl. Come on now, girl. Come on, we can't cater. Oh,
yo, what did you think of Trick Daddy's comment?
I love that he's trying to rile up the internet. Does he have an album dropping or something? Like,
I love it.
He knows what he's doing, right?
Yeah. Like, everybody's entitled to their opinion. Listen, Trick Daddy is absolutely a motherfucking legend. And I salute Trick Daddy all day, and he's entitled to his opinion. And I just think he's wrong.
Yeah, he's allowed to be wrong, too.
He's definitely right.
Listen, not only can Hov rap, but that was the interesting part to me when he said...
He said Hov can't rap, or
he said who... We can actually insert the audio, but...
Beyonce ain't trying to give back the music or nothing. That Beyonce don't write music, and Betty can sing her motherfucker. Beyonce can't sing.
I don't like Beyonce.
Okay.
She definitely can't sing.
I don't know why they be thinking she can sing. They just...
Man, I watched my godmama train Beyonce, give her vocal lessons all her career, man. Unpopular opinion right now. Beyonce is to R&B what Jay-Z is to New York. That's why they together. Jay-Z ain't never won the greatest rapper alive. Whoever put him on a level of that. New York lost Biggie. They needed a hero. They wanted to be the mega of hip-hop, and they just handed it over to Jay-Z. The first time y'all ever heard of Jay-Z, he got on a record with some down sound called Big Pimpin'.
Yeah.
Man, I heard him on the hard read.
Yeah.
And y'all, they'll tell y'all right now, that's Jay-Z song. And you'll go Google, and they'll say, yeah, it's Jay-Z song. Right?
The South put him on.
But they ain't going to tell you Jay-Z bought the song after the bitch got big.
That's UGK song, man.
Yep,
and, well, that ain't nothing about that record. It's no East Coast New York record. Nothing about that.
Nothing.
And then at that time, what East Coast came and got a from the South to do a record with him, man?
Right.
But I would push back on Trick and say, there's nobody who knighted Jay more than Biggie. People forget, like, Biggie and Jay was like
Jay-Z
this.
And Biggie Smalls.
Biggie was on Rap City. Yeah, they did songs together. Biggie was on Rap City shouting out Jigga, saying Jigga's his favorite rapper. Like, they were, like, Biggie recognized and saluted Jay while Big was alive. You know what I mean? So if anybody knighted Jay, and if anybody had, you know, every... I don't want to say right, because nobody had the right to the throne.
Mm.
But if anybody was like, if it was first, what's that shit called? First rank voting? What is the shit? Whatever that shit's called. Jay-Z was Proper definitely
number two.
Two or three. I say three.
Fair, because Nas was kind of moving. But also the people at the end of the day, like, exalt the figures that they care
about. That's
right. So it's like, we decide that Jay is that. Like,
that's right.
You could call, every rapper out here calls himself the best rapper, right? Like, you see every single one. Motivation. I'm the nicest, I got this, that, the other. But like, the people don't, and the people think that Jay-Z is nice. You
and
can't
he
deny
is nice.
It.
Definitely nice.
Because he's nice.
Nice.
Yeah. I don't care what you think about his politics. I don't care what you think about, like, his choices or that. But at rapping, he is very skilled.
Never changed.
I told Angelina and Envy this morning, and we weren't even on the air. We were just having a conversation behind the scenes. Jay-Z is, and I love Mary J. Blige, but Jay-Z to me as a man is what Mary J. Blige is to a lot of women.
No, real shit.
It's just the truth. Shit. And I love Mary. No, like, Mary is... I love Mary like women love Mary, too. But Jay, from Reasonable Doubt to 444,
raise you.
He's raised us.
Yeah.
Like, there's a Jay-Z bar for every motherfucking situation in life. Everything.
That's
like,
interesting.
Come on, man.
He's a real OG. I've never seen him smoke cigarettes.
Huh?
I've just never seen him smoke cigarettes.
Okay. But yeah, he's the guy. So I mean, like, you know, that thing Trick was wrong in that aspect. And I think Beyonce can sing. And I think it's unfair. You know, Mark Lamont Hill asked him, you know, if Stephanie Mills, Whitney Houston are 100s, what is Beyonce? He said 85. Stephanie Mills and Whitney Houston, that's a different level of
that's
talent, bro. Like, there's only one or two of those ever in the history
God
of life.
God gave them some.
And just like with the total package of Beyonce, that's a once in a generational talent too. But just vocally, come on, Stephanie Mills and Whitney Houston, don't do that. That's not fair.
Has Beyonce ever been criticized for her lack of ability to sing? I thought that she was always considered a
great entertainer.
Not to me. I've never heard it.
But she's not a good singer?
I think she developed a better voice.
So initially it wasn't as good.
Taylor, you cannot take the Beehive this week. You just can't
all
do
the
it.
Smoke, yo.
Why do y'all think that you I just give can't... a fuck
oh,
about
shit.
Oh,
my
God. Oh,
don't
shit.
Do that to them.
Hold on.
You just said fuck the Beehive?
Really? That's what I said?
That's what I heard.
You guys sound
don't play around
crazy.
With them, yeah.
I said
she was average. I feel like at Destiny's Child.
You said
and Destiny's Child, why can I say she developed a better voice?
You said Beyonce was average? Whoa.
Y'all are so
is that what you just said?
The things
so
that you
don't
say
think you said
as a Pinkett Smith, Winfrey knows Carter, I'm disgusted.
Stop hyping shit
you
up.
You don't want this, Taylor. Leave it alone.
Stop
don't
hyping
asking
shit up.
For smoke, yo. You're asking
how am I asking smoke. For smoke when I'm saying her voice got better? Like, she
you
did
said
that.
She was average.
I'm not
that's
lying.
Like,
but you're saying, I'm not saying that she changed, she stayed the same. That's like
she improved her voice.
Yeah,
gotten
like, better. She did good.
But she's
like,
never
initially,
been.
You're saying that she was trash?
I did not say that. See,
or just not as
she's
good.
Never been average.
Shit talkers,
she's above average.
Beyonce's never been average, bro.
And Destiny's Child?
Never. She was the lead singer of Destiny's
she's
Child.
She's the lead singer of Destiny's Child.
She was the lead singer.
Yo,
but
yo
no,
son.
That's
she's
that's
the
so
wild. She's the lead singer of Destiny's Child.
That's because she's the lead singer does not mean like
stop.
She...
Although, who had a better voice than her
she's the lead singer of Destiny's Child.
You don't think Kelly Rowland had a nice voice? You don't...
No, I said better.
Better
had a better voice.
I personally
what about the
like
religious
Kelly
one?
Voice
what about the religious
than,
one?
Been
Michelle?
And,
Michelle.
And Luke and
Michelle. She got a book out checking in right now.
She gave her...
And Destiny's Child, I appreciated Kelly Rowland's voice.
That's,
yes.
That's beautiful. But God didn't want Kelly Rowland
no,
to be
her
successful.
Dad didn't want no one else to be the leader except for Beyonce.
I love Kelly Rowland.
Yeah.
Kelly Rowland is the Godiva chocolate goddess. But Beyonce has always been the best singer in Destiny's Child.
I believe so.
Come on. Like, what are
come
we
come on, yo. Like, do we have to play the music?
What are we talking about?
You didn't sing the song.
Like, do we have to
it
play
it? It wasn't
like,
auto-tune.
What song did you want to hear?
Why are you upset You just said everyone got their own opinion.
I'm just
so
trying,
why can I say
I'm
my
just trying
opinion?
To keep you away from the goddamn beehive.
Y'all are stretching.
You ain't never seen my girl. Thomas J got killed by the bees.
That's a fact.
Right
I
now,
that's a fact.
The week you haven't, the bees fuck you up, Taylor.
First of all, zap, I have, zap. Excuse me. Let's zap, be very clear. Zap. Let's be very clear.
Okay.
All the Taylor shit makes me lit. And on top of I have a lot of other people supporting me and everything else. Like
I haven't
that,
seen
even
it.
Even though y'all don't.
Yo, Reddit's starting to flip on Taylor. They're starting to support her.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you know, a sympathy.
Nah, they're
why
like.
Why are you hating so much? You want to fight?
What do you think? You saw it for real?
I saw
a post. I really don't be looking.
I saw a post.
It's too cruel. I'm going to be honest with you.
Nah, I saw a post.
I think honesty without compassion. Yeah. It's brutality. And I see a lot of honesty with no compassion. I'm like, yo, I can't watch this.
They
I don't
said
like,
that
I don't yeah. like to see them doing that to you, Taylor. I'm being honest.
They said that she's the Dr. Fauci of the Brilliant Idiots podcast.
Yeah. Whoa.
What's that?
What? Whoa.
What's that? But,
they flip it. They don't like Dr. Fauci no more.
Well,
they,
no, I mean, yeah,
that's
him.
That's the point. Yeah. Every time he comes around, shit just shuts the fuck down.
Damn. I looked on Reddit. They say look like Taylor. Never mind.
Say it.
Nope.
Say it.
Say listen. It.
What?
She's lit. It makes her more lit.
It makes you more lit. Yo, that son. Is a misconception, though. You should not think that way, Taylor.
Why?
Yeah.
Because that's not true. All publicity is not good publicity. Just because people are talking about you don't mean
it's
a good thing.
It doesn't matter because guess what? I don't know who these little people are anyway.
Oh, they little. Why they gotta be little? First of all, I don't think they're little. They are listeners, and I appreciate them. Yes. Really needed subreddit. Shit. Let's
I appreciate
go.
The support. You. So guess what? They're gonna keep listening every fucking week.
Not for you.
It doesn't matter.
That's what they want you to know, Taylor. I'm only speaking. For Reddit.
I'm still here.
Listen, I love you. You know I do. But I'm just speaking for Reddit right now. Those are the kind of comments that makes them shoot at you on Reddit.
And did you think it bothers me?
Yes.
Yeah. Why? We why do y'all think it bothers
yo,
me?
Show of hands if you think it bothers Taylor.
But why? No, for real, why do y'all think that? No, give me your honest opinion. Why?
Why do you think
do
it?
I show it?
The way
do
you
I...
acting right
yeah,
now?
Yeah,
the way you're acting right now.
Yeah. Oh, literally.
You are salty.
Was I acting like that the other time? A
lot of sodium.
You are upset right now.
A lot of sodium, yo.
You are pissed.
Yeah.
You're pissed.
Chicken Pete's fries. You Chicken Pete's fries right now.
You're a girl on
you
fire.
Chicken Pete's fries.
Yeah. This lemonade.
Yeah,
you got lemonade album right
guess
now.
Guess what? I have other work outside of this and it's very stressful.
What's stressing you about the Black Effect?
Listen.
I didn't say anything.
Work is work.
Yo, there we go, Charlotte.
People gotta work. Like, you gotta work. People gotta work.
Hey, Charlotte, tell them, bro. It's white people, we've been telling people this for years. Yo, work is work. Whistle while you do that shit if it makes you happy.
Whistle while you work. Go ahead and start it. Make that pussy party. Whistle while you work.
Yo, we are so musical today, guys.
This is Brilliant Idiots, the musical. Listen. Oh my God.
Come on, bro.
What the
hey,
fuck?
Hey, free Michael B. Jordan, yo. He's just
what
trying
to Michael
name
B?
He's just trying to name his rum after
he locked him up?
No, he deserved it.
Exactly. He was
no, he deserved that backlash.
Why?
He because here's the thing. And
he's
it's
trying
the
to be black too much almost.
What?
I know. No, don't make that face. You know what I mean? It's the same thing. You say white girls and everything else, and you just automatically start to turn black or something like that. Like,
hello. What?
She's showing that every
girl. Why are you acting like I'm you? No. Y'all not about to do this.
Giannis.
Stop shooting threes. Y'all not about to do this.
If you're going
to
play, go to the paint. Giannis, stop shooting threes.
Y'all not about to do that.
Giannis.
Hold on. You know exactly
Taylor,
what I mean.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
You're about to call Taylor John Fick.
No, I don't.
I hate y'all. I'm just ready to fight.
She out here shooting. And shots, man. I'll just, man.
And then what was so great is she shot at Michael B. Jordan. No. Alex ain't saying that. Bow, bow, you like white girls too.
I'll say nothing. Taylor literally said, it's almost like Michael B. Jordan trying to be too black. And then Al just goes, what? And he goes, first of all, you be taking white bitches, you Puerto Rican, you're not even black.
She
said,
no.
She said, you know how you be trying to break white girls.
Took out his black card so fast.
Yeah.
Fine, I'm putting it to this. All I was going to say is the same rule.
Why you think he take black? I mean, white women. Why he take white women? Because they've never done that shit to his ass.
But what's so crazy about it, he named his wine Juve.
Yeah.
It's a lot of Caribbean people who don't even like to be called black. You know what I mean? But that has nothing to do with nothing to me.
It's rum.
The problem with what Michael B. Jordan did is what corporations do. They come to these conclusions about things without having those people in the room. Because all you had to do was ask a Trinidadian, hey, what do you think about us naming this rum Juve?
Yeah.
I'm sure the Trinidadian would have gave him an honest opinion.
But Juve is a party for them.
You said what?
Juve is a party for them. It's the start of carnival or something like that.
Yeah. Yes, it is. But it's also something else too. I saw people from Trinidad.
Juve is
speaking
a contraction.
Speaking from someone, okay. I spoke to a Caribbean. y'all about to make me like go off on this.
Go.
Why?
Break down the Juve thing. Break down the Juve thing because I did read that as a contraction.
Yeah. Well, no, just I didn't. What's up?
You're not saying shit.
You ain't saying nothing, man. Why you playing ISO basketball today? You're stopping the offense.
I was about to say something.
Like, give me the ball. Give me the ball.
Now hold it like
this. Holding it. What's up?
I was trying to finish my sentence, but you started laughing.
Okay.
Yo, okay. You started laughing, Charla.
Go ahead, all right, let's go.
Hater.
Come on, yo. Taylor, stop. Hammer time.
Can't touch it.
Taylor!
But that's all you have to do. Listen, corporate America, it's really a no-brainer.
Yes.
Whenever you're doing anything cultural, just bring in people from that culture.
Exactly.
You won't make these mistakes.
Juneteenth, sell watermelon fried chicken.
Shut up.
At all the places. Yo,
that's another example, though. IKEA
in Atlanta. In Georgia, bro. Yeah. In Georgia.
But the black employees complained and said that they didn't even consult anybody black when they did this.
Well, tell the story so it doesn't seem like I just made that shit up.
Oh, no, it's true. In IKEA, IKEA in Georgia, in Atlanta, put together a Juneteenth menu. I guess it was for their employees, and they have fried chicken and watermelon on the menu. Now, somebody told me that if you Google Juneteenth food, that's what comes up. So I don't know if that's true.
You know that white people Google everything anyway, so it makes sense.
I will say this,
and
though,
I wouldn't be mad either.
You remember we was in South Carolina a few weeks ago,
mm-hmm.
and we went on the boat with our white comrades,
mm-hmm.
and you know, my white homie was like, "Yo, are you flying out today?" And I said, "No, I'm flying out in the morning." He said, "Yo, come on the boat with us, man."
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, "All right, no doubt." So he gets on the phone. He's like, "Yo, Charlamagne's coming on the boat with us." He's like, "Yo, make sure to get the food out ordered." He was like, "I want the chicken tenders from Publix." And he was like, "I want watermelon." And
no.
And I want hummus.
No.
Right? And I'm sitting there like, now, I heard him say he wants the food he ordered. So clearly he already placed this order, mm-hmm. right? So it's fried chicken and watermelon.
Yeah.
So we get on the boat. Oh, man, when I say our white comrades was killing this fried
rocking.
Chicken.
Oh, we love fried chicken.
Bruh. I mean, kill it. And I don't even eat fried food, but I'm sitting there, fucking it up. All the white people fucking it up. So I said to myself, man, let me try one of these goddamn chicken tenders from Publix. So I tried one, ended up eating four.
Which is real.
They was
Publix
fucking
chicken
good.
Slaps. Yes. Oh, wait, we had them in Florida.
In Florida.
Publix chicken tenders.
You got to come in the black box, right?
You got to get the potato salad and put the potato salad in the chicken tenders and eat it like that.
Oh, I'm definitely beating you.
And the rotisserie chicken.
I never had the rotisserie chicken. But my point by saying that is, fried chicken and watermelon should not be a negative stereotype for black people.
It's a delicious food, bro.
That's
yeah,
it.
Period.
And
delicious
and
food.
And I looked it up
it.
Today because I've never researched it ever in my life to see why it's a stereotype. It's only a stereotype because white racists back in the day made it that way. Because watermelon, after slavery, they used to sell it. Like people, like the people that used to be slaves, the black people that used to be slaves used to sell watermelon.
Newly freed
for
slaves.
For profit.
Yeah.
And for some reason, watermelon was a symbol of freedom. Mm. And so that's when they put a negative connotation on it. White people.
Like we.
And with chicken was easy. Easy
delicious.
To make.
Delicious.
Easy to get.
Yeah.
And what made that a negative stereotype was the movie Birth of a Nation. Because in Birth of a Nation, it was all of these politicians sitting around. And one of them was like, really sloppily eating chicken. And they said it showed a lack of table manners. And being that it showed a lack of table manners, that's why they associated it with Black people, because they thought Black people were like unclean and didn't have any cool for anything like that. So the negative connotation came from racist bigots. So why would we let them steal our joy?
Yeah. I'll be pissed off if you didn't have watermelon and fried chicken. I'm like, you're not paying attention. If you give me a bunch of finger food and shit like that, what the fuck is this dumb shit?
Yo, but how shitty is that, that like, if I invite Black people to a barbecue or to like a boat ride or something, I can't have watermelon there without y'all thinking I got watermelon for y'all.
If you had hummus, we gotta have hummus.
We gotta have cauliflower. We all gotta suffer through this fucking lunch because y'all so sensitive
y'all
about delicious food.
By Starbucks and shit. What the fuck is this dumb shit? You forgot I was coming?
I know. I might get that. Hey, I might get that shit this weekend. But no, that's true though. I want nice hearty food.
So how do we? That's good. This is good. How do we approach? So for the white people listening right now, how do you approach the Black people you invited to your party? And say, look.
I think it's the assumption.
Well, I think you got to say it ahead of time. Be like, yo, listen. I fuck with watermelon chicken. You going to see it at this goddamn party? It got nothing to do with your ass whether you come or not.
Now, I'm going to feel like you fucking with me.
Just
if you announce it, if you announce it, I'm going to feel like you fucking with me. I'm not.
Yeah. I smoke Newports.
Oh my God. Well, you white.
What's that mean?
What? this guy, come on, son. What, bro?
If you announce it.
Come on. I listen to Dead Prez. This is my part.
If you announce it, I'm going to think that you fucking with me.
Yeah.
Or have it there. You walk in, you see watermelon, you see strawberries, you see grapes, you see all types of fruit.
Chicken, fish,
whatever.
If we ain't got no Starbucks and no finger food and stuff like that, then I think you fuck them. If it's just watermelon,
it's just
chicken.
Watermelon?
No, fuck
and
you.
Chicken.
Fuck you.
It's mixed together. It's a salad with watermelon and chicken.
I need the potato salad with the raisins. When you got that shit there, I'm like, okay.
Huh?
No, I don't want it, but if I see it at the white person's house,
I don't do that, bro. White people don't eat potato salad.
With raisins? Yes,
we don't eat potato salad. That's fake.
Chicken salad.
Chicken salad.
No, no.
Now, I'm not going to lie. Chicken salad sandwiches.
Chicken salad's gone. Y'all see Subway admitted that there's no tuna in their tuna?
Yeah, tuna is a tuna thing.
They have no tuna in their tuna. How you got a tuna sandwich and there's no tuna in it?
I want to know what the fuck is it then.
You used to eat that shit all the time.
I eat it all the time.
All the time.
When I go to Subway, put me a scoop of tuna on that motherfucker.
That's not tuna, bro. Cat?
What is that?
I mean, what else is it going to be?
Taylor, what do you think it is?
What's the closest thing to tuna?
Huh? What's the closest thing to tuna?
Yeah, fish,
old
right?
Panties?
You right though.
I'm just saying.
Jockstrap.
That's it.
So stupid, I'm just saying. Oh my God.
Come on, Taylor.
That was kind of funny. I can't believe she ain't laughing up that one. That
yeah, how she not laughing? That
was an alley-oop. You kind of did
an alley-oop. Taylor? Taylor, can we pay some bills? At least?
I got them. I got bills.
What is that song?
Can you pay my bills? Can you pay my mobile bills? Can you pay my automobile bills? Bills.
Oh, we killed that shit.
I like that
one. We killed that shit.
That's how Taylor sound running downhill. Listen. All right, let's pay some bills.
She's already shooting, Alex. You got to laugh. You laughing kind of hard, Alex.
Yeah, you laughing too hard.
She was mad.
You laughing too hard, Alex.
She already shot at you, man.
I'll put too much sauce on.
Yeah, that's a lot right there.
He got
man.
A good
a
laugh. And once he got him going, it's
that
over.
Was his get back laugh. I do like white girls. I do like white women.
Yo, she said he be trying to like white girls. Like, so you know how you be trying to like white girls?
Al, how you try to like white women?
Son. Al just said what? He didn't push back. He could have not heard what she said. He just goes, what? Taylor want to laugh so hard.
Oh my God.
Taylor want to laugh so hard to be with the gang. Listen, Taylor want to laugh at the gang so hard, yo.
Let's pay these bills, man.
Yo.
We're going to come back. We're going to talk
you
to Taylor.
You
want to
know what's fucked up?
What?
Taylor?
What?
Can I tell you something that's fucked up and I thought was rude of you?
Taylor, you can't sit there and pout.
You can't pout.
Excuse me. I'm not pouting. I'm actually trying to look up to find more
Ask it idiots, but these aren't good questions.
Oh, now you hating on the Ask Idiot question.
Oh, I have a suggestion about that.
Okay.
I think the Ask an Idiot should come from Reddit. I think
great idea. And then crowdsource.
That's it.
Yo.
I think y'all should have y'all own thread for Ask an Idiot.
So the mods on Reddit, I don't know really how Reddit works that well, but that's a great idea. If you create a post for the questions,
yes,
and then the community upvotes the really good questions.
That's right.
Now we just read the top few questions.
That's what y'all should do.
Yo, Reddit, we don't really understand Reddit that well, but if that makes sense, could y'all organize that?
That's right.
Appreciate y'all.
Create an Ask an Idiot thread. I think that's what it's called, a thread, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we old as fuck. You hear us?
Hey, man, proud to be.
I was going
to
shoot back.
Wait, what you going to shoot back and say?
And they'll still take a long time to be read out loud.
Oh, you just... Hey,
we the same height, for real.
He's shooting back.
Puerto Rico! Oh, Puerto Rico! Oh,
Lower Marion!
All right, let's pay some bills. Okay, salute to Keeps. Thank you, Keeps, for sponsoring the Brilliant Idiots this week.
More than let me read this one. You bald as fuck, bro.
That's the point, right? I thought that was the point. Okay, I'll do the first line. You take it away.
All right.
More than 50 million men in the U.S. suffer from male pattern baldness. I am in that number. Okay. I am in that number. Now, there's nothing else I can say about this that you would believe me. All right. So take it away, Andrew.
Yo, Keeps, man. I'm telling you, you want to keep your hair as simple as that, you go with Keeps. I've been using Keeps for over a decade now. And the same active ingredient that's in Keeps now. Now, obviously, I'm on the Keeps, but the same thing I've been doing. And I got all my hair. I noticed my hair was going, and I had to get on top of it early on.
It does look like it got a little healthier, bro.
I'm telling you, bro.
Wow.
It's not a game. You got to get on this shit, man. It's serious. It will come back. And you're with a baldy on purpose. You could grow hair.
Now I look stupid.
I'm just saying, some Keeps might get you looking good. Anyway, point is, you got to get on it and get on it quick. Make sure you do it before I lost your thing. Make sure you do it before you lose all your hair, okay? They have incredibly affordable options that you can do. And you're going to get your first month free if you go to Keeps.com.
That's right.
And you make sure that after you go to Keeps.com, that's KEEPS.com, and you go to /idiots, okay? Keeps.com/idiots. It is convenient, all right? Virtual doctor consultations, medications delivered straight to your door every 3 months. You don't even have to leave your home, all right? And you can loosen your grip on your wallet because Keeps is low cost. Treatments start at $10 per month, and Keeps offers generic versions to keep that price down. So remember, if you're ready to take action and prevent hair loss, go to KEEPS.com/idiots to receive your first month of treatment for free. Now let's get back to the show.
Let's do one more. Let's do Liquid Death, man.
Let's do it.
Gotta salute Liquid Death. Liquid Death be showing up for the pod.
Yo, I love that. Okay? That's my favorite water, bro.
Listen, so many of us go through life dehydrated. Thirsty. You about to go grab one? Go grab one. I hope you brought back enough for everybody. Oh, shit. Here we go. Now, I never thought I would drink something called Liquid Death.
But it's very refreshing. This looks just like liquor.
Because it's in a can, Wack.
Cheers. As Taylor just said, it's in a can. Easier to chug a can and way more fun, okay? It feels like a beer, you know what I mean? If you're at a cookout or something
now
this summer.
Now I won't be corny because I don't drink.
That's right. If you're at a cookout this summer and you don't want to be the guy that looks like they're not drinking, just grab a Liquid Death. Don't even let people know it's water because people are going to look at that shit and be like, damn, Liquid Death. Like, yeah, youngin', you can't handle this.
Yeah, you don't know nothing about this.
It's for OGs. We used to get bit by roaches. You know what I mean? You can get 2 free koozies with your first order of any case of water at liquiddeath.com/idiots. Just hit up their merch store, add the koozie 2-pack you want, and you'll get it free with your first case only at liquiddeath.com. Thank you, Liquid Death, for sponsoring the Brilliant Idiots. But no, it really, 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 really is refreshing, man. In a real way.
So,
all right, now let's do some church announcements.
Okay.
Let's get back to the show. You got any church announcements, Jotzi?
Oh, I do. This Friday, tickets go on sale for a few new shows. We added a few new shows. We're going to do one in San Francisco. We're going to do Vegas. We added another show in San Diego. That one sold out. And we added more tickets for the special taping in Austin. So make sure you check those out. I'll give you those dates real quick. TheAndrewSchulz.com. Those are where you're going to get the tickets that are not scalped. I keep telling you guys, I want y'all to save money. So if you go and get it from The Andrew Schulz, you're going to save the money. Simple as that. So again, if you want, we got San Diego. We added another show. First one sold out. Thank you so much, San Diego. That's on September 16th. We have more tickets being released for the special tapings. That's September 19th and 20th. Go right now to do that. It's going to be in Austin. And then October 2nd, we're doing Las Vegas at the Venetian Theater. And then we are also adding San Francisco. That'll be November 6th, San Francisco at the Masonic Auditorium out there. Beautiful, beautiful theater out there. Go check those out. We also had another show, Minneapolis. Go get that, man. The infamous tour, theandrewschulz.com. Go check that out. Also, we had a pretty wild interview with Alex Jones on Flagrant.
Alex Jones.
That's a wild motherfucker. So as long as it's still on YouTube, go check that shit out.
Wild boy.
That's a wild, wild
Alex
boy.
Is a wild, 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 wild boy.
The wildest.
Wax, you got any church announcements?
Yes, sir. Up in L.A., my flower is still there, the Who's Wax brand. We just now did something with Jay-Z, so it should be in more stores very soon. That's really dope. And I'm doing a collab with Buddy. It's like the biggest mobile dispensary in L.A., B-U-D-D-E-E. I mean, make sure y'all check me out on there, too. And Bully and the Beast, we got that on every Wednesday. Howl at us. Mm.
Absolutely. Same for me, blackeffect.com. That's where you can go to, subscribe to all the podcasts on the Black Effect Podcast Network. Tamika Mallory, State of Emergency, How to Win in the Country We Built. That's out right now, best-selling book. And Anita Kopack, Shallow Waters, a young adult fiction book. That's the second release on Black Privilege Publishing. That'll be out August 3rd. And We've Got Answers. You heard me mention it earlier, talking about Eric Adams. He's one of the people I got on We've Got Answers on Audible. That's it.
Love it.
Let's get back to the show. Now, let's get into some shit you won't care about next week. We got to start off.
Oh, my God. How have we not spoken about this yet?
Our guy.
How have we not spoken?
Our guy, Vow of Big Neck. Carl Nassib. Is that how you pronounce Carl's last name?
My God.
So. Nassib, yeah.
Carl came out, and he's the first actively gay NFL player. I didn't know that. I thought Michael Sam was the, I guess, I did say active.
He never played.
I thought he made the Rams.
Yeah.
He got drafted, but they cut his ass.
There's so many gay guys in the NFL. I guess he just came out, though.
No guy's been out. There was that dude that played for the Patriots for a minute. What was that guy? He was like offensive line.
Aaron Hernandez?
Nah, but he's gay. Yeah, he's gay he too, found man. His gay.
Who are you talking about?
There's a white guy. I forgot his name, but he was like, he played for the Patriots for years.
I don't remember.
And he came out, but after he retired.
Well, there's plenty of guys.
There's mad gay dudes.
Do y'all think it matters, though?
What do you mean?
If someone's gay or not?
Yeah. Nah, like, should there be an announcement? Because I don't think there should be an announcement.
Oh, you're not gay, though.
Yeah, you know what?
It matters to Carl.
But I'm saying, shouldn't we just appreciate someone for who they are? Like, who
we are appreciating
not,
who
not
we
not
are.
Not appreciate, but as in, like, who, why do we care who we sleep
he said
with?
That. It was really interesting.
He wanted to be
his,
free.
His video was dope. He's like, look, if you know anything about me, you know I don't want any attention. I'm not doing this for any attention.
He really don't. Play it.
And like,
but why do you?
Yeah, if we have the video, you can play it. But if not, I'll just tell you real quick. And he's like, I don't want any attention. And he goes, but if me doing this could make one young kid feel like they don't want to, you know, kill themselves or whatever because they're gay and they can't come out, then that's worth it. And I'm going to donate $100,000 to this suicide prevention thing for LGBT.
And it's good to be free.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He wants to be free. Now, listen, I say it all the time. You know, who somebody's fucking is none of your business anyway. So you got two type of people, right? You got people who don't want people in their business.
Yep.
And you got people on the download. Either way, that's their business. You know what I mean? If Carl wants to do a video and he wants to say, hey, this is who I am, salute. But I like Carl. He's a good dude. He's just a good human.
Peace,
Carl is a good human. And he's right. He don't be liking no attention. He'd be low key. He'd be cool. Yeah. He'd be minding his business. I like the dude. You know what I mean? I just want people to be happy at the end of the day.
He also said this. He was like, I wish that we didn't have to do this.
Exactly.
He literally said, I can't wait till a time where like a gay player doesn't even have to say this because it's so normal.
Exactly.
And I think that we all want that.
Of course it is. And it's just sad.
Of course it is. Like, you think Carl's the only gay man in the NFL?
No way.
Of course not. Yes. It's like that in any industry, but guess what? People don't have the courage to come out because guys that are gay don't say anything about it. And you know, I don't know why they don't want to say.
Because you got to go in the locker room.
It's because it goes back to Adam and Eve and shit like that. That's the originated, like, it's supposed to be men and women. So that's why people don't like seeing.
No. You mean there's a religious component?
Yeah.
But I think a lot of guys be going inside the...
Wow, think about it.
I think that's part of it, but I think it's deeper in religion. I think some of them feel like they don't want to make anybody else uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable, exactly. Like in the locker room. You're in the locker room and going to the showers. Tippy Toes wasn't allowed to go in our showers because he knew that he was telling all the girls.
Wait, what?
Tippy Toes in college. Like when we all go in the showers, everybody like, hell no, Tippy Toes can't come in here because he was telling all the girls our size. So he wasn't allowed in there no more.
Wasn't because he was gay. It was because he was going back telling girls about
it was
y'all
other
dicks.
It was other gay guys on the team, but we still like, they knew
they
like.
They kept y'all dick size to themselves.
Yeah.
What? That's real.
But they
that's
even
real.
Still chilled out because really they didn't it. Want us uncomfortable. You know what I'm saying? They don't want people, they didn't want to hear somebody even chuckle when they came into the inside the showers, nothing. So they just fell back, let us take a showers, and they went and did their thing.
I would be perfectly comfortable if I was ashore.
Yeah, that's dumb, though. Wait,
I would be perfectly comfortable if I was ashore. See, I know I'm a grower,
if you were
not ashore.
Yes,
that's
exactly.
Right. So if homie is in there, and he's like, man, you know, I look at a little thing. Like, God damn, bro. You, like, come on, man.
You spreading fake news about my dandelion.
Now,
I got to get hard in the shower. I don't even want to get hard in the shower, but I got to get hard in the shower.
Now I
got to
show you so you can go back and get the girls a real
report. Come on, Tippy Toes. Measure it up.
That's right.
Nah, Tippy Toes is wild.
Girls talking about it anyway, though, because girls are going to talk about y'all dick size anyway.
Not
so why would
not want them telling them?
Not if they haven't seen exactly what it is.
Not if they haven't seen them. See, this could be it's like a bad Carfax, right? So a homie's in the locker and he's looking at other people's penises, right? And he's going back and he's telling girls, oh, he's small. So now girls are like, I ain't even going to waste my time.
Yeah.
Well, girls are doing that anyway, regardless of
him. Not if I never seen
it. I don't
dick.
Want him to do it. Her homegirl to
girls
do
never
it.
Seen dick.
And when the girls see it, they hard because they hooking up with
that's
the
right.
Girls.
Yes.
Or you put your hand in your pocket and you play around with it.
Way, the girl's going to find out and be like, oh, and then spread
it. We'd rather them find out by themselves.
I don't let
guy.
My wife see me fresh out the shower.
It's you never let a girl see her completely
hell no.
Yeah, are you on drugs?
We in the bed with you trying to make you do wild shit.
Okay.
When do you show your girl when you're
when it's hard.
When it's hard or so
when it looks like this liquid death can.
Y'all been with, y'all.
I'll let my girl see my dick soft. Never.
No. Still, she hasn't.
I tuck it.
Lies.
I tuck it between my legs.
No, no,
put your hand in your pocket, yo. Put your hand in your pocket.
It's embarrassing.
You better beef it up.
No, I'm not lying.
I flick it a little bit.
Yeah, you gotta do something. You gotta smack. You gotta do something.
I'm not lying.
Yep.
Put some
blood
in that shit.
You never show girl your
if he sleep, you in trouble.
Very insecure.
Yeah.
Very insecure.
I show her hard.
Even after y'all are done, like you never just
we go to sleep
out. We talking about
stomach. I go to sleep on my stomach so I can protect my dick.
Just so she don't grab
my drawers. I sleep in boxer briefs.
Yeah. Just so she don't grab it when I'm asleep.
Right. Don't do that. Don't do
she only sees my dick hard. You know who I am. Say my name. Say my name.
You feel the same way?
We got time for that shit.
Really? That shit bring back a lot of trauma, man.
But I'm saying,
you know,
like now, like
it bring back
years?
A lot of trauma because I've been with my wife for 23 years, and I remember she used to keep a little diary, and I found her diary when we was like real young, and it had like guys' meat sizes. In there.
Yo, your wife is a wife.
And she had me down as small.
How many?
Damn,
real
talk. For real?
How many meats you need a diary, bro?
It wasn't a whole book. It wasn't the whole diary. Wasn't about it. But the
Excel
page.
Spreadsheet shit. South Carolina dangling.
The page had a couple guys on there.
Why
and
is
like,
she so petty?
Oh, that sucks.
She wasn't petty. She was keeping a record.
But
and
what?
And I remember reading this shit, and I'm like, oh, I can't admit. That I read
it. You can't say nothing.
Maybe that's why she put it there to see if you read it.
Get some meat pills.
That fragile ego spoke for me. Because, you know, you sitting there trying not to say nothing. He's like, hey, that got a little dick, yo. She like, what? I read your notepad, yo. You have my name. You have small next to it. You know what she hit me with? You know what she hit me with?
Nah,
I must have saw while you were sleeping or something. I guess. Like,
fuck. That's fucked up, bro.
It was cold outside.
That hurts forever.
Your dick is 8 inches in the summer.
Now.
So, with all due respect.
Hey, man, I've been ordering Magna RX pills for a long time. Them shit might have worked over time or something, okay?
Bro, but how big do you think it grew?
I don't know.
I'm just saying, what was
she? I've always been all right. So, it's just like when you see that, it's kind of like a shock, like, huh?
Don't you want to know what she was you know, taken. It was big.
No, no, no. I know what it was.
What?
Whoa.
She saw it when it wasn't hard.
Oh, this is before you guys ever had sex.
No, this was. This was definitely like this. This was after. This was definitely.
son, what Beyonce song do we have for this? This
one. It's showing big ego.
Got a big ego. Got a big ego.
No, it's a soft spot though, but. To salute the Carl. That's all it boils down to.
We forgot about Carl.
No, I got Carl, man.
Son, what is people. Happening right now, bro?
This is the Brilliant Idiots. If you've never joined this podcast, hey. This is the roller coaster ride we take What's you up? On, okay?
Fuck, dude.
But nah, salute to Carl.
Sounds like she had some roller coasters.
Oh, my God.
I don't remember nobody in there being big, though. I'm lying. I'm just
you remember the name and everything.
I remember his fucking name to this day. Okay.
You know how it was written in cursive or not?
I remember his name to his day. To this day.
to this day.
I feel bad for y'all, man.
Why?
Cause it can't grow. Y'all could
like, you got the smallest dick in here. what you talking about? A clitoris ain't nothing but a little dick.
That's
you
all
got
it
the
is.
Smallest dick in
it
here.
It's a little dick having ass.
That's why you keep saying suck my dick every week.
Yo,
that's what this is about.
Point.
Okay, you might want to suck your little
well,
dick.
Well, technically, actually, all y'all had pussies before. Like when y'all were babies.
That's actually true.
Yeah, that's true.
Women. Everyone starts out as a
I told
woman.
You why. No. You don't believe nobody.
You start out with a vagina, bro.
Yes, you do.
Because you start out with a vagina, testosterone masculinizes the brain.
It's like a tadpole.
I understand. When I come out, I already have my meat, though, right?
You already had your
like, when this motherfucker came? Don't tell me I had a pussy when it came out and then I grew a meat, nigga. Like, nobody remember us when we was young, you know what I'm saying? Fuck that. I'm just saying.
So that came out already.
Oh my God. What do we think of Nick Cannon? Spreading his seeds early. He's about to have baby number 7.
Okay.
Oh, I thought that
he
this was the 4th
sets.
One born this year.
That's what I'm talking about.
Wait, with different women?
Yeah.
Yes.
Lil Duval tweeted that Nick Cannon having babies like he about to die. Like he know he about to die or something. And then the Shade Room posted that clip on Howard Stern where he basically was like, he don't think he's going. Yeah. I don't see the problem.
I don't see the problem either.
Would you do it?
The 4th baby this year with how many different women?
4, I hope.
4, because he got 2 sets of twins.
Is it 4?
Yeah, because he got, don't he got 2 sets of twins?
That's 2 then.
Listen, I don't see the problem. Nick Cannon, number 1, he can afford it.
Yeah.
Right? And number 2, when I heard that he was having another baby, I said, Nick is a very strategic person. He's doing this for a reason.
He knows how.
And it's some people that do that. It's OGs out here that's like, y'all want to spread my seed.
How do the women
Yeah,
feel?
But exactly how I
I'm
feel.
Sure
like,
have.
I just
sure
feel like mind. At the end of the day, they're probably, well, I know I'm going to be good because I'm a Nick Cannon, blah, blah, blah.
Y'all
but
don't know what kind of understanding Nick got with his women.
Sure
you don't know
dope.
What conversations they
I know, of course not,
having.
But I'm just saying, it just seems like,
it don't seem like nothing. We got to stop
Which,
assuming.
No, no, no. Let me ask you a question.
You can assume a little.
Andrew. would you do it?
No.
Like, you don't understand.
Ideally, I would not have 4 children in 1 year with 2 different women.
No, say, no, ideally. No, say you're in his position.
Yes.
And you have a sickness or whatever.
Yeah.
Would you be, like, just spreading wildfire?
No, because I would want to spend as much time as I possibly could.
That's
with
why
those
I'm. That's
kids.
What I'm thinking.
Yeah. That don't mean he's not though.
Mean?
Why do
they
act like he's
because
not?
Because he's a busy
all
guy
the
already.
Same roof?
That's what I'm saying. Exactly. They're not all on the same roof.
So
that's
what?
All I'm saying. Like I just would want
a coach,
all the kids.
Y'all are making a lot of assumptions.
Come on, man.
And a
so
lot.
So you think
of
all? So all of them are on the same roof then?
No, they may not be on the same
by.
Roof. That don't mean he can't spend time with them.
I'm not
it
saying
means
that.
Spend
We're
less,
not saying
right?
that. Yeah, like
it means he'll spend less. We know that for a fact.
Sure.
So like. Ideally, and again, you guys have kids. I don't have kids, so I'm completely ignorant here. But like, I'm sure when you have kids, you want to be around them as much as you can.
Yeah.
So there's
and I'm sure,
blessing.
And I'm sure Nick will spend
he
as much
sure
time as he
the birthday parties.
I'm not saying he wouldn't be a bad dad or anything like. Or I'm saying he is one. I'm just saying, I would want my whole family. I wouldn't want to just keep spreading like.
I don't, listen, I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't think it's anything wrong with it because it's actually kind of dope. Like, you meet different women that you vibe with.
They down.
And it's like, it's literally like breeding.
Yes.
Like, you're breeding with different, you know, individuals. Fire.
So what future,
all the kids, so all what the kids have, all the kids, all the kids.
So what Future is doing is fine too then.
You said what?
What Future is doing is fine too because he has how many baby moms?
If it's strategic.
As long as he can take care of them kids, it's okay.
That's what matters at the end of the day.
That's it.
What matters is, are you taking care of the kids? Are you in the kids' life? Like, what else matters?
The birthday parties, they all come together. All the moms understand what their situation. They all come together.
We're
he
also
comes in when he needs to.
They all understand, right?
Exactly.
We're making a lot of assumptions.
I don't know.
About...
Hopefully they do.
And by the way, you can have one child from one woman that you don't fuck with and never see that child.
That's a thousand
of
million. A
of course, but so then why?
Percent.
Never
mind.
And have and don't have no money to take care of that child.
Look, I'm not judging him. I know he got the money and everything else. I just think it's kind of a little reckless, just like
kids don't
know.
Want money.
Exactly.
Yeah. Like, they don't know nothing about it. Yeah.
I'm sure he'll give them time.
Yeah,
man.
I'm sure. I'm sure you have them together.
It is what it is.
Listen, all the people that I know that got one kid go through the worst problems. Because that baby mother don't want them to ever have other kids with nobody else. She's like, your experience with having kids is always going to be bad. All the people what? I know that got multiple baby moms, you don't understand, that's crazy. A lot of people who I know who got multiple baby moms don't have that many problems at all.
That's not.
All the dudes that I know that got one baby mama got huge problems. I'm just telling you.
He's giving you examples, Taylor. You don't have no examples to back up your argument.
She's never
going to
do it.
Wax gave you
great examples.
Okay, and I'm basing off of, again, Back to Future. He has multiple
you
baby moms.
But how you know his situation?
Yeah, but you don't. What do you mean? It's public.
What's public? About that he got a bunch of kids?
No, about the child support and everything else like
okay,
that.
Okay,
like,
he pays child support.
You don't think that's a problem or nothing like that?
He pays child support? What's wrong with paying child support?
So you're not a good father if you got child support?
You're supposed to pay child support.
No,
you ain't supposed to pay
she's
child
trying to
support,
expose him like he's a bad dad and everything else like that. So, like,
you're going to get that from
woman.
That's just going to be what it is. I ain't got nothing to do with it.
That's
all about the kids.
You got seven baby mamas and only one is complaining. I think you're
doing a great job.
I'd love to be 6-1 in the NBA Finals.
Believe me, you rather that than only have one baby mom who take you through hell. I guarantee you. Anybody I know who got multiple baby mamas, that one woman going to get them together.
And it's the old school way of doing things, right? Like back in the day, like people weren't necessarily married. And when you slept with another individual, it's because you were going to have a baby.
That's how it's supposed to be.
And back in the days? Yeah. I grew up in the country. Everybody had two families.
Really?
Or more, yes, for sure.
This was interesting. T-Pain feeling depressed after Usher comment about his music. You can insert this one too.
I heard a story about you and Usher on an airplane.
This was so interesting to me because, you know, my whole life, my mom always told me and my dad, we don't know how to talk to people, right? And we in this era where everybody thinks like, you know, honesty is the best policy. True. But honesty without compassion is brutality. Honesty without empathy is cruelty. So Usher telling T-Pain, hey, you killed music, bro. You're killing music. Like you fucking it up for real singers. That's it?
But didn't Usher hop on that fucking auto-tune wave immediately?
No.
Yes. I don't remember Usher hopping on the auto-tune wave.
But he could actually be singing.
He used it a little bit.
He used it.
Yeah, but auto-tune's been here for a while, though.
I mean, that's Roger Troutman.
But I
think certain people understand certain ways you say certain things to certain people. You know what I'm saying? I don't think you should always be nice and compassionate about certain things because people ain't going to listen. You go ahead and tell me certain things and be nice, I'm like, get the fuck out of here. But you got to be like kind of stern when you actually say certain things and be brutal.
What do you mean by stern, though?
You got to be brutal sometimes to certain people.
I don't know if I agree with that. I think with Usher, right, because you got to give a solution. You can't just tell me I fucked up music, I killed music.
He should have asked. T-Pain should have been like, okay,
what do you mean
explain.
By that?
What
do you mean by that? Because I feel this way, right? If you're a real singer, to me, it's about the song. If you're a real singer who makes a great song, you still going to cut through.
Always.
Because you can use auto-tune and make whack songs and nobody will give a fuck. It's about the song.
Period.
T-Pain was making great records. I don't give a fuck if he was using auto-tune or not.
And he can sing.
Early on he couldn't. He did get better. I remember I made him sing live. He'll tell you this story. I made him sing live at Hot 103.9 in Columbia, South Carolina, and he was horrible. And I used to have this drop called Babunki, Babunki, Babunki. You are Babunki. And I gave it to him. And he called me so fucking mad. Because this was the early days of shit going viral. Yeah. So he left Columbia, but then went to like Detroit or something and heard the audio. And he called me so mad. But then when I interviewed him on Wendy Williams years later, he said that's the reason he started taking his craft serious. Yes. And he stopped smoking mm-hmm. cigarettes. And he started taking vocal lessons. So he got better. Mm. You know what I mean? So early on, he wasn't
the best. That's what I mean. He needed that from you. Yeah. You had to be brutal sometimes. Some, you know what I mean? People probably told him, yo, bro, you ain't going to make it. You can't really sing. You can't really sing. Mm. He's like, ah, fuck it. I got auto-tune. You told him the truth and made him actually do the right thing.
No, it's just a more harsher truth, though. It's not like you're making fun of him.
Some people need it.
It's too different.
Yeah. It just depends. Yeah, you just got to read the room, man. You know what I mean? But I just think that you can really be honest with no compassion. It can come off brutal and cruel.
Yeah.
That's why I talk about Reddit.
Yeah.
some honest shit being said.
Some people need it, though.
But it's cruel.
Yeah.
Some people need it.
What's up? What's the honest shit? What's the honest shit?
Wow. Not just in general.
You've been starting with me for a minute. Like,
what are you talking about?
Why
do women the honest shit?
I gotta ask one question.
Okay.
Why do women do that where they bring back the timeline? Like, she just said, honestly, Charlamagne, you've been starting with me from the beginning of the week. Like, why does your transgressions go back to Monday? Why can't we just talk about like, what's happening right now?
Like Captain America.
Yeah, what's happening?
Take those stones back and reset these timelines. No, the honest truth is, it's the honest thing that they're saying about Taylor on Reddit.
Yeah.
She lost the race.
She did get fucked.
She got washed.
Son, you
got your ass busted.
At least three seconds.
Why didn't you drag your ass a little faster? Talk about dragging.
Yes.
Well, when you got a baddie money, behind man. You, like I do, it's kind of hard.
I got fatter ass than you. I got way fatter ass than you. I go. Do. I so, got the wag. Go. I got
man,
the wag.
All y'all got little dicks anyway.
Do, yeah. Oh, you heard that? She went right to little dicks.
All y'all got little dicks anyway.
We got little dicks out here.
I appreciate
fat ass little dick. How silly that look. Come on. You think I got fat ass like this and the little dick? You crazy.
Thank God.
You know what I mean?
But, I mean, listen. But, I know I've traumatized people like this.
What?
Telling them. I've had friends who told me, you told me such and such years ago, and that shit fucked with me.
Yeah, but it actually got them better.
I don't know if it got them better.
Well, I think it breaks people, right? It's like the people who are destined for success are going to be motivated by it, and the people who are not can be crushed by it.
Yes.
And it does separate.
You know when I really learned that? I learned that with my daughter because this is a few years ago. She was running track. Mm. She was doing the long jump. I'm pretty sure I told this story.
She was doing
the long jump, and it was at practice.
Yeah,
and she was terrible. So I go, yo, that was terrible. Burst into tears.
He's wrong.
You know what I mean? Honesty with no compassion.
You also say read the
room. Joke with her though?
You don't play around with the kids.
Do you joke do you joke with her though? And then she just took it a little.
We joke with her more now because she's older. She'd be 13 this weekend.
How old was she when you said that?
She's like 8 or 9.
But is she used to you like kind of being, I don't know.
But I wasn't joking though. I was like, yo, you terrible.
Yeah, that's not cool.
I wasn't joking.
Yeah. Read the room. You gotta know the situation.
But she probably knew too. So it probably got
she
to
even
him,
though she was just heard this is dad. Yeah. And dad told her, dad, like, I don't say things like that to her. I've never told her anything like that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Kids come to you with a squiggly thing on paper and be
like it's amazing.
Look at this eagle. Oh my God. It's the most amazing. Great. You know what I'm saying?
Like, you'd be like, get it out of here. That sucks. He'd be like,
you don't do that. You know what I mean? Like, come on. Yeah. Don't do that.
Because your approval means so much.
Everything. Yes. You start thinking about, I think about the things my dad said to me when I was young.
And you're like,
that at 42 still fuck with me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He might call me sometimes and ask me for something. I'd be like, man, fuck that. Remember when I was 15?
I need a bike and a tube.
Word is gone. I get mad at my dad now for shit that happened to me when I was a teenager. Like, yo, get over it.
Yeah.
That's my therapist. My therapist never told me to get over it, but it is what it is. Yeah, you know what I mean? He did the best he could with what he had and the emotional intelligence he had.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But I remember my dad smacked the shit out of me for running this. I think I told this story too. Have I told this traumatic story before?
What
happened?
When he was driving and I was following him when I was like 15, 16.
Oh, no. Yeah.
And he ran the stop sign. So I ran the stop sign. And then he pulled over and got out and slapped the shit out of me and told me to wake up. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, what? Motherfucker, I'm following you.
Do
you
as I do.
Stop sign.
Wait, was it do as I do?
Oh, that was his favorite line. Do as I say, not as I do.
Yeah.
Huh? The fuck?
Yeah.
But yeah, that's the shit. Parents' approval means every motherfucking thing to people.
That's a fact.
That's it.
It is.
That's it.
That is a fact.
So salute to T-Pain and just everybody out there, remember, honesty without compassion is brutality.
Mm. Only for some people. It could be free for some people.
Shit. Let's pay some bills.
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's pay some bills, man. We got one more. Squarespace. Salute to Squarespace. You know what I'm saying? Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. You'll find what you need, whether you're showcasing your work, blogging and publishing content, selling products and services, announcing upcoming events, or anything you can dream of. Buying a domain from Squarespace is easy because there are no hidden fees or price hikes, and get to know your audience with their analytics tools. Those include insight on page views, traffic sources, time on site, audience geography, and more. It's also simple too. Start with a design template and use drag and drop tools to make it your own. All websites are optimized for mobile. Your site looks great on any device. Every Squarespace website and online store comes with a suite of integrated features and useful guides that help maximize prominence among search results. These SEO tools are paramount. Head to squarespace.com/idiot for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, use the offer code idiot to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. That's squarespace.com/idiot with offer code idiot for 10% off your first purchase. Let's get back to the show. Let's do some Asking Idiots. Now, if you've been listening
5 minutes outside after this, Charlamagne.
I'm just saying, if you've been listening to the podcast, Taylor has been searching for Asking Idiots for at least 40 minutes.
They're asking like dumb questions, though.
Okay, we got Asking Idiots.
I only have like a few because they're not like, okay. You want to read the other ones?
This is a good one. CH_music. If social media had a flavor, what would Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, etc. taste like? I actually like this question.
Cool.
I think all of them would be bitter. Ooh. Depending who you follow.
Sour patches.
If you just open yourself up to anybody's energy on social media, it's going to be bitter.
It's like an airhead.
Sour patches. Airheads?
Yes. Yeah. Airheads are great, by the way.
Sour as fuck in the beginning. Uh-huh. The lozenges. Sour as fuck in the beginning, but after a while, some sweetness comes
out. Yeah, you find something to laugh about.
But that's when it happens. Yeah. You got to curate your page. You know what I'm saying? You got to let certain followers in. I think every single social media site is bitter until you curate your motherfucking page. You know what I'm saying? That's all.
That's cool.
Okay, let's see what else we got. Ooh, this is another good one. ARSHD_S. Do you think the bullying trauma you guys faced growing up benefited you?
Hell ooh. Yeah.
Go ahead, Wax.
Hell yeah. My father never told me that. Always told me, like, you'll never be nothing and all that type of shit. Made me always want to be like, I'm going to prove my pop wrong. Everything I did, I was like, I'm going to prove him wrong. With my sisters and them and brothers and them beating me up because I'm number 10. Mm-hmm. I needed that. Now I'm a monster out here in these streets. Like, I really can't lose too much. You know what I'm saying? I think that, you know, me being messing with a lot of girls when I was young, I seen a lot of dudes out here who get pussy and be pussy whipped and like stop their whole life all worrying about the girl, chasing the girl. Pussy ain't shit to me.
What do you mean? You mean when you got molested when you was
young? Yeah, like molesting. Also, like, I started real early. Like, pussy was never like nothing to me. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So I could leave a girl in 2 seconds and be like, all right. Like,
well, maybe because you didn't understand the value of it because you were getting molested.
Yeah, and it lost it. It lost the whole vibe. Even right now, like, pussy's not going to get me. You got to have a whole
trauma
lot more.
Response, though.
Whatever it is, I think it. I really appreciate it because I've seen a lot of dudes fall victim over girls because of the pussy, or they go crazy
Wax,
over the girl pussy.
You were falling victim of the pussy, though.
Nah, when? Come on.
Before, Carla, you were, like, saying, like, I remember the stories, like, you're going to say no to a girl, da, 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 like, with sex.
No.
Like,
I mean, falling victim, what I'm saying, dudes lose their life. They'll go crazy if their girl cheat on them. They'll go ahead and do, like, wow.
They're not used to vagina.
But, okay.
I don't think being molested helps you.
I feel like, really, I feel like, in me starting early dealing with girls, pussy, I lost value of it. I lost the,
I actually,
you know what I'm saying?
Everything what he's saying makes a lot of sense. And like, people go different ways with it. But like, you know, there's a lot of times that people who deal with some sort of sexual trauma when they're younger are completely desensitized to sex, and then they can go into industries that are really difficult for the average person. Mm-hmm. Like they can go into mm-hmm. sex work, you know, they can be prostitutes, they can make strip and that kind of stuff, because sex has been removed.
Yeah,
the value of
it.
And
that's why I don't think it's a good thing.
I know it's
not. No, I think it is, because what I seen what pussy do to other people fucked them up. I seen dudes stop playing football because they think the girl gonna cheat on them, stop coming to practice. I seen dudes fight their best friends because, yo, he looked at her and he's like, the motherfucker not even looking at your girl,
bro.
Yeah,
but you don't want to be desensitized to sex, though.
All right, but what if, you know, all the dudes who's going crazy?
His reaction is that since he doesn't have the same value on sex, that thing isn't going to drive him.
Exactly. Yeah, and it drives a lot of people. A lot of people I know, pussy and their girl, they don't want to leave home. They following, they putting trackers on her car. Like, they going crazy because where's that pussy going right now? Me, I'm like,
I hate that you had to get molested to go through that.
I mean, just ask for the trauma. Did the trauma help us out? Yeah. Me fighting all these years for my sisters and stuff like that, did that help me out? It was trauma at first, but I appreciate it. My dad telling me, if somebody else's dad telling me, man, you ain't going to amount to nothing. You ain't going to be nothing. I know why he was doing it. You see what I'm saying? And I was like, I took that as fuel. Like, what?
Not me. I believed it. I'm like, damn, Pop telling me I ain't going to be shit?
You know how you tell a boy, you can't do no push-ups. You can't do no push-ups.
But to Wax's point, I did believe my dad when he told me that if I don't change my lifestyle, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm going to have a fucked up life. I mean, he did. My daddy used to say, you're going to end up in jail, dead, or broke under the tree. I believed him. So being that I believed him, I did things to make sure that I didn't end up in jail, dead, or broke under the tree.
Yeah,
100%. Do I think the bullying and trauma help? That is a good fucking question. I don't know. Because, you know, I was talking to my Sacred Purpose coach. I was talking to a few people. I was talking to Debbie Dev and, you know, Angela Rye and Anita Kopacz and yada y'all. But, like, you know, that's my tribe. And they was like, it was like, you got to embrace the whole totality of you. Because a lot of times we try to suppress the versions of us that went through that trauma. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? We try to act like that person never existed. You know what I'm saying? We try to act like the person that either experienced trauma or caused trauma or unintentionally or intentionally hurt people, we try to act like that person never existed. Mm-hmm. But you can't run from any version of you. You have to embrace every version of you. That's why I thought the Mary J. Blige doc was so dope. I don't know when it comes out, but the My Life doc, because there's a part of the documentary where she's watching an old video of herself when she was a kid, and she's talking to her young self with such love.
Wow.
She's like, oh, that's my baby. Look at my baby. She was like, yo, I protect her. I protect her, and I protect five-year-old me. And that shit hit me, because I'm like, I watched it last night, and I just had that conversation, you know, earlier that day. So it's just about embracing every version of you.
What's the youngest video you got of yourself? I don't remember nothing.
Video? I ain't got no video.
Me neither. I ain't got no fucking video. Born in the 70s. That's what I'm saying. I ain't got no fucking video of me, man. What up, y'all?
She was a star, though.
Respect.
She got sound. She was like 18, 19. You know what I mean? Peace. But she had pictures. But you can look at pictures of yourself.
Yeah, pictures ain't shit. I want to see myself. Like, I want to see the fuck I was doing young.
You
had
no videos?
No video. I mean, I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't know if the bullying and trauma helped. I'm TBD on that one.
I think I go through way more bullying now than I went through when I was younger.
Because of social media?
Yeah, don't you? Like, when you're younger, you got like five people making fun of you. Now you got...
I can deal with that, though. Because you know what made the bullying so bad when we was young?
What? Because you cared about
what cared.
These people actually knew us.
Yeah.
You had to see us tomorrow in school.
Whoever this
born. That's what I've been saying
this whole time. You see my shorts I had on for three times this week.
Wait, what? Oh, she was saying
they knew.
I can't wait to fight Charlotte after this.
But no, here's the thing. If people comment, here's the things that don't bother me.
Hold on. You think you'd win if you fought him?
I'm about to fight you right now.
Because I would never, I would never hit Taylor back. I would run.
That's the thing. I would too, and I know I'd be able to get away.
So you can't catch you?
If I ran, you can't catch me.
I would run.
Think
like,
about
you
that.
You lost another race.
Another one. But for real, though, that's a fact. You can't beat me up because you can't catch me. How does that feel?
Ooh. I'm right here, nigga.
Oh, shit. I got scared. We're in a tiny room, guys.
Let her swing for 5 seconds.
Wax out!
I think Taylor will be so winded after 5 seconds of swing.
Yo.
Yeah.
I think you get.
Why y'all want to stare me up like? Why?
Well, she did three minutes. She did 3 minutes of playing. She did 3 minutes of playing. She got 40 seconds.
40 seconds stamina?
Why?
What?
Why do y'all do this shit?
Do what?
Because I'm tired of all y'all right now.
Do what?
Because you literally said the same thing I said when it came to Reddit. But of course, when you say it, it's not a big deal or whatever. Like, everyone agrees and everything else.
That's not
but
true.
Then, Yes, it is.
No.
I was literally saying, why would I care about people I don't know?
Well, it depends what they're saying.
Depends. No, it doesn't.
Saying. No, it depends what they're saying. See, you I don't care about stuff like when people are like, oh, he got a white wife. You know what I mean?
They found out your wife, his wife? How'd they find that out?
Because stuff like that we know is not true. Yeah. But they can say they say things about your personal appearance and you'd be like, shit.
Yeah.
Kinda, like no. When they make fun of your nose.
Nah. I don't like when they make fun of your nose, honestly.
I don't care about
that. What are you talking
about? That bothers me.
I do it first.
Okay, when they made fun of your sneakers, that hit you on Instagram a little bit.
That shit hurt, bro. That shit hurt, bro.
It does. You know what I'm saying?
It wasn't even.
It's little things. Like yo.
Even a quote tweet, bro.
Like, yo. When people be like, yo, they be like, yo, you know what? Schultz and West got a little point. You know, Charlotte's stomach a little such.
That shit gets to you.
Okay, all right. Well, now I'm a diet.
Yeah. I got new Tims. But they fucked
you
up
got,
again.
You see what I'm saying?
What you doing?
Why one look new, but the other one don't?
Because I was grilling, right? And I sauce.
Oh. Because one look new and the other one look like it's the one that's been...
I was,
but I don't
ashes
need
got on
comments from people to tell me when I need to... Like, it doesn't... Mm-hmm. I don't get it.
You don't get what?
I don't know. I just feel like...
I still feel threatened. I still feel threatened.
So I
feel threatened.
So do you think...
You threaten me.
So, do you think the bullying and trauma helped you, or you don't?
I think
I'm TBD on it.
I think it depends. I think it depends on your constitution. I mean, it can definitely be motivating, but I also like to like create scenarios that don't exist to motivate me. You're the person I need to be. You're my enemy. Blah blah. Like we never even had a conversation.
Yeah, that's something I'm trying to work on. I've been trying to work on that.
Self motivation.
I shouldn't like conflict, bro.
But it's too much fun.
You do.
I know what's wrong with me. I'm good under pressure. I'm reading this book right now called My Grandmother's Hands, and they talk about that. They talk about you can have certain traumas, and some people's trauma response is when it's chaos.
They're the best self.
They calm.
That's when they're calm.
They're the best version of themselves. Yeah. That's definitely me. Because when it's peace, I'm like, what the fuck? Okay, when is Wax's Tim going to drop?
My girl won't even, we can't go on a vacation where we just relax because she goes, you don't know how to relax. So I was like, why don't we just go to the beach or some shit? She goes, you don't know how to go to the beach. We need to do activities or you're going to start getting like anxious and like upset and all this other stuff. I need things to happen. I need to do things. I just have never learned how to sit down and relax.
It depends where I go. If I'm in Anguilla, all day.
I still need to do something. You see me, I got to get four wheels. I got to do something.
Activity.
I have to.
But it could be surfing. It could be fucking a yoga class.
I'll be going right with you. Let's go in the boat. Let's go do something.
I need a thing.
I get drunk.
Nah, honestly, I can't do that.
That's my favorite shit.
That's the only way I get around it. If I get drunk enough, that's the activity.
Because you don't feel like an alcoholic. I'm drunk on the beach.
Yeah, vacation, you're never an alcoholic.
You know what I'm saying? You don't worry about what you're wearing. Always got to do
whatever. I've been here on the weekends, and I can't believe I'm here on the weekends. It's like, I got to do something. Like I'm here on the weekends. I got to fly out somewhere. If I'm not flying at least once a week, something ain't right.
Being busy is a trauma response, guys.
Yeah.
Just staying busy is a trauma response.
Yeah.
Being busy just for the sake of being busy, is a trauma response. Like actually not having anything to do.
No, I got plenty of things to do.
I'm gonna work on that shit when I'm retired.
Yeah.
All right.
I gotta retire.
Let's see. Let's scroll up some. I don't even want
to
play with
I'm about
David
to pee
G.
my pants. I'll be back. You guys go.
All right. Okay, though you might need to be here for this one.
All right, go.
Victor 557. Would you rather spend a year in solitude in jail or catch Wax's poop for a week?
No, say that again.
Catch his poop with what?
Your hands.
Oh, barehanded?
Yeah. Would you rather spend a year in solitude in jail?
Why are you doing that to
him? Hold on, y'all. I eat watermelon and kale.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
I just saw you eat some yams, mac and cheese, and all the other shit.
I didn't have mac and cheese. I didn't have mac and cheese.
Y'all
I had fish.
Wild.
I had fish and greens and fruit.
So what? That's not kale and fucking watermelon.
Fried fish.
Salute to Paul.
Greens.
Fried fish.
Exactly.
Paul is in Hackensack.
Yeah, Paul.
Last week you had a hamburger and everything else. So shut up.
Taylor?
What are you talking about? You had it right with me.
Exactly.
I know, but we're not talking about me. So we're talking about you. How I didn't.
But you talking about me? So I'm telling you
that I eat watermelon or kale. You just did.
For me to shit in his hand. Like, I make sure I eat clean that fucking week before you have to go to fucking jail. I go to jail then. Fuck it. I'm not arguing about it.
I'm definitely catching the poop in my hand.
Come on, I'm not arguing with you.
I'm not going to jail for a year. A year in solitude? Hell no.
Hold your bite of wax. I'll pay for your food. Just go eat fucking vegan or something.
I actually would want you to fast. So then you wouldn't poop that much. You know what I'm saying?
But why are you making it seem like it doesn't matter what you eat? You're still gonna, it's still poop though.
Like, it's sometimes it's green cleaner. Poop is different poop.
Imagine if you put your hands under there and it was diarrhea.
Eat pork.
Yeah, that's disgusting. But
pork and all this other type
poop.
Of shit. Come on, man. No. Cheese.
The poop's not gonna smell.
So you'd rather
no
go to jail?
The poop's not gonna smell no different.
You crazy rather go to jail for a year?
No, I'd rather catch the poop. I'm just saying the poop's not gonna.
No, I could tell when somebody's stomach is rotten, when their inside is fucked up, when they take a shit.
Word up.
And when somebody's okay. If I walk out the bathroom, you can't even tell if I shit or not. Word I know up. Some people, you can't even walk past the bathroom. That shit is steaming out of there. Real shit. You can't even walk in the house or the hallway of the bathroom. Me? Nah. I'm chilling.
What else we got? What else we got? Let's see. Scroll
there
up.
There wasn't that many.
Let's see. Let's find one more before we get out of here.
Well, look. Here is some.
What?
Because more people are on here. I didn't put them on there yet. Dre 23, 1985 wants to know, what are some major fundamental ideologies you guys disagree on?
Huh?
What are some major fundamental ideologies you guys disagree on?
What is that? Like an idol?
I don't know. I don't know, because we talk about everything. So it's like we have conversations about things, and I think that Brilliant Idiots has always represented a platform to where even if you do disagree on something, you listen to the other person enough to maybe be like, that's a good point. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think we have major disagreements on any ideology. Not right now. I don't think so. I could
be ideology?
Okay, well, I won't wait till Andrew gets back.
Andrew though. Taking a shit.
But what is that?
Well, I was going to say, what's do ideology? Y'all...
Like your ideas, like things you believe in.
Whatever people believe in, they believe in. All right.
So it's Caesar_GL wants to know, what do y'all think the Sixers should do with Ben Simmons?
What do I think the Sixers should do?
Try to motivate him. Find a way to motivate
Word
him.
Word is born. They treating him the way Usher did T-Pain right now. That shit is fucked up. Like, you can't do that to him. Because he's either going to respond one of two ways. He's either going to go to the... He's going to take all that shit as motivation and work on his game during the offseason. Or he's going to go in a deep, deep, deep depression.
Y'all mean,
and not want to show himself no more.
Light skin.
Word up.
Just saying real shit.
Yo.
So you sometimes you don't
Word
like if
up.
I know like my even my light skinned boy and stuff like that, I don't do it as I don't get them as hard as I get the guy that's dark skinned who's well
Are
done.
You for real?
I'm just real shit. My light skinned boy, some of them I just don't
You like dark meat.
No, it's not that. I'm just trying to tell you. They understand better. Like, I feel like a dark skinned dude is well done. And he's not gonna be more emotional than
Never ever met a dark skinned emotional guy.
No, he's very dangerous. If you got Tyrese. Dark-skinned, emotional guy...
Tyrese, that's what I'm going to say. Tyrese.
But I hear what you're saying. Does Tyrese sing? Tyrese sings...
Genuine. Because he's a singer?
He sings. It's a little different. If you got a dude like me and I'm emotional and I act light-skinned, shoot me. Because I'm coming after everybody.
You can't be emotional, why?
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Imagine me emotional. I'm gonna fuck somebody up.
I have seen you emotional.
No, I've seen you emotional.
You're like, you were saying, like, where? What do you mean?
And I'm talking about emotional to where I'm like.
You was emotional over your ex-girlfriend.
Man, I can't. Bye. If you ever think this idiot show is whatever. What you be saying? Time to go.
No, but Ben Simmons psychologically is already fucked up. That's why he don't like shooting.
Yeah.
That's why he didn't take that fucking dunk. And he passed the ball to Tobias Harris. Like, he's already psychologically fucked up. There's something in his head that's already there. All his past week did was make that shit worse.
So, I didn't watch the basketball game. So, can you explain to me why they're so harsh on Ben? Because I didn't see the game. Because
he don't shoot.
Yeah.
He's
like,
literally
this whole
scared
season,
to shoot.
That's why they were upset with him?
Yes. First, they say he couldn't shoot. Now, they say he's just afraid to shoot.
Yeah.
So, and they're saying he has not improved. So, and they think that he has all the talent in the world, which he does. But he hasn't improved his game.
I think
he
got
to know how to take
games,
that criticism.
The last three games, I think he only took a total of 14 shots.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah, like with 9 points.
Yeah, that criticism,
like that.
he got to know how to use it for fuel. He using the flight.
But you don't think the tough love is good? Because people haven't given him such a hard time at the end of a season. They just was like, whatever, we'll cut.
And that's what I think it is. They say he baby.
I don't think love is tough, man. I think it's a lot of things that we say that like brutally honest. Like, I don't think you have to be brutally honest. I think when you're being brutally honest is when you're, like I said, having honesty without compassion. Mm-hmm. And I don't think love has to be tough. You know what I'm saying? I think if you love somebody, I'm going to tell you the truth, right? And I'm going to just tell you the truth. And I think people understand intention. You know what I mean? Like, T-Pain would have received that totally different from somebody who actually genuinely loved him. Because when you truly love somebody, your intention is different and the way you say something is different. You know what I mean? And I'm not saying that you got to be easy on a person and not, like, just be straight up with them. It's just the way that you talk will be totally different. Now, like, you talk different to people you love.
No, all the people that I like don't really know like that, and I find myself like talking to people and helping people out, I'm really more easy on them. The people that I know, I'm on their heels because I feel like you're supposed to already know. Already. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? I'm really, really on your heels. I'm not giving no sympathy to you at all. You know what I'm saying? I cut one of my other people's off not too long ago, and I kept it straight 1 million. Like, nigga, you supposed to fucking know this type of shit. I'm not going to sit there and be like, and he expecting sympathy. I'm like, I'm not fucking no fucking sympathy for you, nigga.
Do you think you could be, you think you're too harsh on the person that you really fuck with because you know that they know you better. Love them? But no, that you know that that's my, they no. know that Wax is my guy.
No, I feel like only reason why I'm harsh on you because I know you could have did better.
Got you.
You know what I'm saying? If I knew that, right now, I tell you to clean that can off the thing, and you just throw it on the floor, I'm going to be on your heels. But why didn't you just throw it in the garbage? Like, you could have did a better job at this. You just threw it on the ground because you say, oh, you said move it.
Yeah.
What you mean? I said move it. I said clean this up. So you just, oh, I cleaned it up. I just stuck it on the floor.
So when it comes to, like, when you say, like, you don't know what people are going through and everything else like that. So when do you, like...
It's hard for me to do with that too.
I mean, therapy has done wonders for me. Having daughters has done wonders for me because I can be honest with more compassion.
Peace.
You know what I'm saying? And plus, I don't know what people are going through.
That's what I mean. So, like, when you're going back, you're saying
my thing is, I go through so much. That type of thing, I don't give a fuck about what people go through.
No, I do. Because I tell you why, because we should have learned this shit a long time ago. I done put my foot in my mouth a lot. Since grade school, whether you do your mama jokes or your daddy jokes.
Yes, and I never did that type of shit.
You're a liar.
Me did mama jokes? No, because I never played that. If somebody did to me, I'm going to fuck you up.
You're a liar.
You never did mama jokes.
Your mama this? Never. We never played that.
Well, I did. And when that person hit you and say your mama dead or something, or, you know, making comments about women's weight. You know what I'm saying? We did shit like that when we were younger. And then
asked him, was he pregnant? That hurt my feelings.
But then you find out woman might have had a miscarriage or something. You're like, oh, shit. Oh. But that's your ass. Because ain't nobody told you to just blurt out, you know, such and such none got big.
Nah,
you
know what I'm saying? Like I said, if I know you can do better, that's when I'm going to give you tough love. I don't give a fuck because guess what? I'm going to give you the consequences because whatever you did, if I'm really on you, if you go to jail, they don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? If you go out here in the streets, they don't give a fuck what you're going through.
Like, whatever the situation is, though. Right?
But there's no honesty or compassion in jail, though.
But that's what I'm trying to tell you. If it all depends on really what you also did. Now, if you coming to me and be like, Unc, I cheated on my boyfriend, he's mad. I'm like, I'm going to give you the harsh truth. You know what I'm saying? About what the fuck it is, because that's what you're about to deal with. I'm only going to start with it, with your... what you about to go deal with. Like, my uncle, my nephew, you know, I'm about to get locked up in jail or something for selling drugs and doing bullshit. I'm going to be on their heels because guess what? This road you about to go through is about to be a little harder. So hopefully what I'm telling you is going to be a little harder for what, and the road will be a little easier. But I'm nice on you, like, oh, you know, a lot of people went to jail before. It's going to be okay. I'm like, nigga, you about to get fucked if you don't be in the right thing. You better be doing your push-ups. Like, what the fuck is you think? What you was doing? Like, I'm going to be really on his heels. If he got an easy road, I'd be easy on him. Like, oh, I got a test and I might fail. I'm like, you should have studied.
It depends on what it is. Like, it's the urgency of the situation, right? Like, if you know somebody's about to, like, do something that's going to cost them their life or somebody else's life, ain't no time for compassion.
Nope.
You know what I mean? But it's other times, like, when you're critiquing somebody's music or something, like, it's other times you have to have some compassion, bro.
Yeah, I get what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like,
how's my weight, baby? You got to have compassion. You know what I'm saying? Like, if a woman be like, baby, how do I look? Am I fat? You know what I'm saying? Don't you have compassion? You don't sit there and be like, nah, baby, you look fat with that dress is up.
I would say, yo, I'm going to hire a trainer. We're going to work out together.
That mean you
no, I'm going to say we. I'm going to hire a trainer for us, baby. We're going to work out together. You know what I'm
saying? Not when she asks. I'm talking about when she asks. You can't say we're going to hire a trainer when she asks. You got to say it before. Like, she be like, hey, baby, how I look? We're going to hire a trainer.
I didn't catch that part. Oh man. No, don't do that.
Don't do that.
Holy shit. You talk about honesty with no compassion.
No, don't do that. You got to just see her coming out like, damn, baby, you look good.
Oh, shit.
Let's get ready for this summer. I'm going to get a trainer this week. We're going to really kill it now.
Baby, how I look? I'm going to hire you a trainer.
I'm going to hire us a trainer.
Holy shit. Can I ask you a question? No, please don't. Not right now. What do you want?
Y'all just talking about compassion and everything else. Y'all don't do shit. Like, y'all do not do that to me at all.
What do you mean?
Which one of us get it?
Taylor, you're a liar.
But that wasn't the question I was going to ask, though.
We are very compassionate.
No, you're not.
Yes, we are. Like, that's a lie. I promise you we are.
How do you figure?
We are compassionate.
Taylor, we are compassionate.
We are.
How do you
very much so. God knows.
How do you figure?
I don't care if you know. I know God knows.
Yep. Yes. We don't even care if you know.
We don't care if you know. That's right. That's right.
We promise you'll be compassionate.
Right.
You're a woman. Like,
that's
come
right.
on.
We are very compassionate.
Y'all do not treat me like a woman, yo. No, y'all don't. Y'all treat me like I'm one of the niggas.
Well, you are one of the niggas.
I am, but granted, I know my personality, but I'm just saying, y'all don't.
Listen, I don't care what you say. I know God know my heart.
Yeah, my heart too.
And I know God know what's heart. We are very compassionate.
What's the inside joke?
I'm compassionate with all. First of all, I'm compassionate with any woman I call my niece. That's number one. Yes. And you know, I'm not volunteering. No more information, no more to nobody.
Nope.
Well, what's going on?
I don't know. They have an inside joke and I want to.
No, we tell her she's a woman we're compassionate about with her.
Ask us any. Okay, this is your one opportunity to ask us anything that you think we're not being compassionate about. And I'll give you an honest answer.
And I do planks.
Okay. Just like you said, you like conflict and everything else. When it comes to the Reddit stuff, why do y'all like to see me?
I knew she hated that shit.
I was going to ask you, no problem, though. Because y'all saying two different things.
I don't like to see Reddit attack you.
But you're encouraging it, though.
No, I just
do it to yourself.
Y'all encourage it,
That's
though.
Honesty with compassion. I'll tell you why. Because I'm saying, Taylor, you don't want that smoke.
Yeah, but then you be like, all right, go. Like...
Because you be awesome, fuck it. Just like how you said Beyonce was trash earlier.
That's not compassion, though.
That is compassion. No, that's compassion because I'm saying, Taylor, you don't want that smoke. Leave that alone. You like, fuck it. I don't
think you had to do is leave it alone.
But y'all also are joking about it on the podcast, though.
I just like Reddit, but I was talking about Reddit before they started Taylor threads. I like Reddit. I enjoy Reddit.
You know what? I think we started the Taylor threads.
No, I don't think that.
No,
I'm just saying.
You're
not smart enough for that.
I damn sure not me.
None of us know.
He have nothing to do with it. Wax definitely didn't do it.
What?
I don't believe you.
You think we started that?
No.
But what was the question anyway?
How are we contradicting ourselves?
I think what happens is we're the type of people when we find out something is getting under someone's skin.
Yeah, exactly. But that's what I'm saying. That's not compassion.
Been like that since high school.
Yeah. But that's what I'm saying. But that's not compassion.
But I'm not like that anymore, though.
But we're not compassionate people. Oh, is that what they were saying? They're compassionate?
We are.
We are.
They lied to you.
No, that's not true. I know I'm much more compassionate than I used to be. I was definitely brutal.
Bravo.
Honestly, with no compassion.
Yeah.
I was brutal. I know I was.
That's like white people in the South going, we're not as racist as when we own people.
Well, we're trying to progress. The fuck?
One step at a time.
One step at a goddamn time.
Now, I was really brutal.
No, for real, for real.
Like, bad.
No, for real, for real.
And I wanted you to be mad.
Yeah.
Yeah, now I
No, this
I
is silly. This is just for fun. But we are the type of guys, when there's somebody in the crew, someone that we care about, someone we love, and something's bothering them, we are going to ride that till the wheels fall off.
Have any of y'all ever
Is that
been-
wrong to say?
You said what?
I was right.
When we know something is bothering somebody in the crew, someone that we love.
But what we was trying to explain to Taylor, we're compassionate because we're compassionate with Taylor.
Why?
How?
Come on.
We're not brutal with her.
Come on. We're not brutal with you, Taylor. At all.
I don't think there's brutality in
it. Yeah, I don't think it's necessarily a brutal thing, but
we
it's
just
not
know
like
how much it bothers
I don't even
you.
Think people being really honest with you, to be honest.
What?
I don't think they're being really honest, to be honest.
Who is?
Alex
who
is.
Nobody.
Alex
Ooh.
Is.
Oh, what are you talking
about? Yes, you are. Why are you laughing? Dude,
you
Who's talking? Not being honest? Wait, what's going on?
I just thought that
on?
Was really funny what he said.
I don't think so.
You've been laughing a lot lately.
There's a lot of inside jokes, and that's what
no,
makes
you
want to have a 5
Reddit got you insecure.
Yep.
Reddit got you insecure. These are not no
Why
inside
do you think
joke.
They have me? Y'all keep laughing at each other. That it's not about ready. Y'all keep laughing at each other.
You ain't gonna do shit to them.
Whatever. No.
Anything
between,
else, Taylor?
Between you and Wax, though, I want to know, like, has Wax ever came to you like, yo, man, I was like, I'm having a hard day. Da-da-da.
Yeah, when his ex-girlfriend.
He's lying.
You think that white girl? Hell yeah.
Look, listen, I'm going to tell you this.
Wait, was that
I did come to him, Wax. But he laughed at this.
No, remember when you came to us?
What like, I laugh at?
It's Monday, Wednesday, or Friday.
What?
Nothing. Well, what you talking about?
No, he deserved that though.
No, I did not.
No, you deserved it.
You probably
I did not
you
deserve that.
Though. You deserved it.
No,
deserved
I didn't.
You do girls dirty.
That's he deserved it.
What girl I do dirty?
And she was a nice girl.
No, I just didn't commit. That's the worst thing I should have did to these girls. It was commit. As long as you fool,
Wax,
fuck
you
fun.
Gave them she was the a nice parting girl. Gift. Like that shit is like.
And I love Carla.
How many, oh, about but to say, what you
think? No, no, no. I love Carla. I love Carla. But I used to like his ex. His ex was a nice girl. Stop. You know what I'm saying?
It's okay.
And I feel bad because his ex actually pressed me.
This about, guy is unbelievable.
About Carla. And I didn't know.
Oh, really?
So she probably think I'm lying now.
What you was saying? Your ex the one that you said was your first true love?
It's got
Carla. We got back together. Carla breaks up with me once a week. We back together. Yes. My ex is actually Carla.
That's good. That's good.
Marshall can ride the bull. He can ride the bull.
Okay. Hey, I got a whole lot. Fuck with y'all, I got a whole lot.
Wax the only man in America who can punch his way out of wet paper bag. All right. Hilarious. That's it, Taylor. Can we go now? You sure?
Yeah.
Speak now, forever hold your peace.
Speak now, forever hold your peace.
I wanted to hear what he wanted to
peace.
Say because he's the basketball guy about Ben Simmons. What should they do with him?
Oh, it's over.
He needs a trainer.
Yeah. He needs somebody to motivate him.
But
he's gonna have a happy life.
So it can't be over though, because if he leaves right now with the same mentality, he's gonna stink it up wherever he goes.
Oh yeah, I mean like it's over for
he needs LeBron.
As a player. But at the same time...
As a player?
No, he's good.
No, he'll be
very
in the
talented.
League for years, but he's never going to reach the levels of his talent.
He's a two-time all-star now.
No, he could be an all-star, but he's never going to do what a guy who's 6'10 and can play point guard should do.
Really?
Why is he over now? This next season and everything else.
Because shooting, you can learn. Shooting is not a part of the game that you can't learn. Like, it is just mechanics at the end of the day.
Now, don't get me wrong. You got some natural, pure shooters like Steph Curry. But think about it.
Ray Allen.
But Steph's dad was Dell, like Clay's dad was Michael. So they probably shot 2 million shots by the time they was six.
You're right.
Seriously.
And maybe a good example of that is like Blake Griffin, right? When he came into his career, he couldn't shoot at all. And now he turned into like a really good three-point shooter.
Yeah.
So you can pick up the skill. He hasn't invested the time to pick up a skill. His form is still really fucked up. He hasn't made any changes whatsoever. And I think he's enjoying life. This is my suspicion. He's enjoying life. He has a max contract. And he's a fucking happy guy outside of basketball. And basketball isn't his only source of happiness. There are certain people where basketball is their only source of happiness. Yeah. And they dedicate everything to being successful. Yeah. Michael Jordan, if he was losing, he was fucking miserable, I imagine. So Ben Simmons, I don't think he's that guy. And because he's not that guy, he won't reach that level of greatness.
Damn.
So he might be happier, bro. Like, here we are feeling bad for this man who was feeling good.
It depends, because I agree with everything that you're saying, but I think that if Ben is not popping, even with the money, he can't enjoy the life that he wants. I think it's a part of Ben Simmons that likes to stardom. Didn't he date one of the generous Kardashians at one point? You know what I'm saying?
That's a good point.
So you got to be the all-star guy with the endorsements.
You don't
got
to be all-star to date them. They date bumps.
that is true.
The environment they in, he still want to be the man
that
environment.
That's right.
You don't want to be a low man in that environment.
That's right. Because at that level, they all got money, right?
Yeah.
So when you walk in the room, what separates you? Your skill set.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that motherfucker's a beast. You know what I mean? You don't want to be the guy like, oh, he can't.
He's just light skinned and tall.
I think they like to date dudes like his son a little bit, though.
You think so?
Yeah, because like, they're not really. I mean, didn't Kim swoop up Kanye when he was in debt $20 million and shit like that? Like, it's not like he was a billionaire, Kanye.
They were friends. Kanye's been in love with Kim forever.
Fair enough. I'm just saying, like, I don't think
they know.
That's what he said.
Why do we say things like that? We know these, like we know.
But that's what he said.
And he was loving her forever?
Like, as in, like, they were friends first and everything. I was like, he always had a crush on her.
Mm, okay.
Well, same thing with Carla then.
Damn, yeah. See, that's what I mean.
What?
I was lying.
Yeah, man. Taylor.
What are you trying to do?
Taylor, is there anything else?
What are you trying to do?
Leave me hanging. I'm going to need five minutes, Taylor.
You sure, Taylor?
I'm going to need 5 minutes with you. Leave me hanging right now.
Is there anything else? Don't leave it on the table, Taylor.
Say it all right now.
You know you want to ask us something. One more thing.
I could go all day.
Go one more thing. Last one.
Ask us the big one.
Ask the big one. Ask the big one. You know
what's the inside joke you two guys have with me?
Oh. Alex, start laughing first.
What are you talking about? Yeah. How you want to throw me
No, I'm just saying, Alex, I want to know why I laugh so much. So I laugh with Alex.
Al hasn't said a word since Taylor spoke to him. I just realized that for an hour straight, Al didn't say a single word.
This is what we're going to do. Reddit, start the inside joke thread. What do y'all think the inside joke is? Brilliant Idiot subreddit. What do y'all think the inside joke
is? That's my question.
Huh?
That's not answering my question.
They might give it to you.
I don't care about
Okay, this is what I'll do. If I see more than 100 of the right answer for the inside
I'm down with that.
I will speak about it next week with some compassion.
Done.
Okay.
Done.
Okay. That's it?
Yamadi Gatsi.
What?
Shabada Ding Dong.
Huh? What? How much is that per plate? Okay. As always, if you listen to this podcast, you think we're smart, you think we're intelligent, you think we're brilliant, you're absolutely right. But if you listen to this podcast and you think we're just a couple idiots who don't know shit, you're right too. It's the Brilliant Idiots Podcast. Thank you for listening. Mm-hmm.